Well, let's talk about Umar first. You know, sometimes it's tough. He played, you know, his career at St. Francis, Pennsylvania, had a year of eligibility, comes to Quinnipiac to do graduate work here and to play basketball. And, you know, he knows all these guys from having played against them the last few years. And I know him well enough to know that he's not the kind of kid that's going to step here and say, I'm the man, it's my ball. He's going to kind of defer. And that's not what Tom Moore wants him to do.
And not only Tom Moore, it's not what the team wants him to do or the team needs him to do. But I think he said, and I think that's a tribute to Umar and to his family in terms of, you know, look, this isn't my school yet. This isn't my place. I'm coming in for 1 year. I'm going to get my master's degree. I appreciate that. But I'm going to defer to some of the other guys. But quite honestly, Quinnipiac, as you well know, we talked about Johnson and Johnson running the backcourt for 5 years. They need those big fellas. Everybody on this team needs a guy in the backcourt with the basketball. They're expecting Shannon to do it. And I'm hoping Umar gets a wake-up call realizing that, okay, I got a chance to have a special year with a special group of guys.
All right. Stay right where you are. We're going to hear from Tom Moore. We will have a scouting report on the Hampton Pirates. Also, the professor, Mike Lyle, back in the studio. He'll have a scoreboard update. All of that coming your way on the Bobcats Radio Network.
This is George Hendinger from Hendinger Farm on Dunbar Hill Road in Hampton. Thanksgiving is right around the corner, so make sure Hendinger Farm is one of your stops to make your feast day complete. If you want to bake an apple, cook an apple, eat an apple, or do anything else with an apple, we have many different apple varieties, from sweet to tart, that can satisfy you. And don't forget to try Annie's Pie Mix, 5 different apples that make the perfect apple pie. We can help you with your Thanksgiving dinner with everything but the turkey, so we've got some great winter squash, other root vegetables, potatoes, onions, and plenty of other vegetables to fill your plate. As for dessert, we have a fine selection of fresh baked pies that come in every weekend. Also, as the weather gets cooler, it's wonderful to get some cider from Hendinger Farm and have some hot mulled cider. We have a fine variety of jams, jellies, and sauces to make your Sunday afternoon football game a great success. Please note that our new store hours are Tuesday through Sunday, 9 to 5, but we're still closed every Monday, so come on up to the High Hill, enjoy the rural atmosphere, and we'll see you soon.
After nearly 50 years serving the community with all your lighting needs, the Lamp Shop will be closing their doors forever on December 28th. I'm Jackie Kaywood, and I want to thank all of you who have supported the Lamp Shop. You have not just been customers, you have been my friends as well. Throughout the years, I have offered great specials on all our beautiful lighting merchandise, but never have the specials been this spectacular. Now through December 28th, I'm holding a retirement sale with an additional 50% off all merchandise, excluding lampshades, parts, and repairs. The Lamp Shop, 993 Dixwell Avenue in Hampton, open Tuesday through Saturday. Thank you for your patronage and your friendship.
The Lamp Shop will be closing their doors forever on December 28th. Join Jackie at a retirement sale and take an additional 50% off all merchandise, excluding lampshades, parts, and repairs.
Welcome back to the Morrow Motors pregame show, everybody. Bill Schweitzer, TD Bank Sports Center. Quinnipiac gets set to take on Hampton, and joining me is Coach Tom Moore. Tom, you know, we were just talking about, before we came on the air, watching this team develop. I mean, all of these pieces are the puzzle. You got to figure out where they fit in, and seems to be a pretty nice fit right now.
Yeah, you know, I think, Bill, that we have a chance to be a good team at some point down the road. During the season, you know, and you obviously hope it happens, and you hope it happens sooner rather than later. I think we have some depth up front. I think we have improved guard play this year, we have pretty good balance of youth and experience, and we've got a lot of things, like everybody, I think, on November 20th to get better at. You know, we have some components, and hopefully we'll put it together.
You know, going back to Saturday's game, you must have been pulling your hair out the first couple of minutes of that game. The team falls behind 11-0, and they looked like they were drowning out there. You must have thrown them a life raft.
Well, I think it was probably more Umar Shannon threw them a life raft, and Zaid Hurst and Usman Drame got a couple offensive rebounds. I wasn't happy, but I didn't really go crazy on the sideline. We called one timeout, tried to get our thoughts back locked into what we're supposed to do, and it was sort of a Quinnipiac formula that got us a little more stabilized at first. Was Zaid, like I said, Zaid and Hoos each had 2 offensive rebound putbacks that got us 8 points, and you know, we went from down 11 to tied to up six at the half. Most of the rest of the getting it tied and getting the up six at the half was Umar's doing. He came out to start the game not aggressive enough on offense. And I was pretty vocal and direct with him at the first time out, because I thought he needed to hear it from me in a certain way. And he responded terrifically and really got aggressive and looked shot first instead of looking pass first. And we need that out of him.
You know, sometimes here's a guy, he's got all this experience under his belt when he was at St. Francis, coming in here, one more year of eligibility. Sometimes you think maybe he's going to step in here and be kind of a little timid, trying to fit in with everybody. I mean, that's the way it looked early on.
Yeah, he's been that way since summer school, yeah. You know, and that's a good thing and a bad thing. You know, he's such a nice kid, so well-raised, and here for his education, really wants to get his master's degree in broadcast journalism, hopefully even in 1 year. And, you know, but he didn't want to step on anyone's toes. I think he had Quinnipiac basketball in a pretty high regard from seeing it as a conference foe, that he felt it was, like, you know, other guys' team, and he didn't really want to make any waves. And he needs to realize, for us to be good, he might, on a lot of nights, he might have to take the most shots on the team. And it was good to see him sort of snap out of the a little bit of the passiveness with the ball early that he had on Saturday.
All right, we are chatting with Tom Moore, and we will hear more from Moore when we return on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Hi, this is Mark Candido, president of Quinnipiac Bank and Trust Company, asking for your help in this year's Hampton Senior Holiday Gift Run. Look for drop-off locations throughout the Hampton area. You will find drop-off boxes at our bank's headquarters at 2704 Dixwell Avenue in Hampton. Contributions will also go to the Elderly Services Programs and the Hampton Food Bank. With your donation, together we all can make a difference.
Through December 16th, contributions can also be made at Whitney Manor, 2798 Whitney Avenue, Hampton.
Let's get it started.
I would have said building a website for our dental practice was like pulling teeth. Then I found the new services center at OfficeMax. Their team got us the perfect domain name through GoDaddy and the right web package for our business. We saved $100. Guess who's smiling now? Let's get it
started. Save 50% now on all GoDaddy web packages, including a .com or .net powered by VeriSign at the new OfficeMax Services Center. Valid in-store only. Learn more at officemax.com/services.
Kenny Rogers is coming to the Mohegan Sun Arena on Friday, December 6th, and we want to send you to see the show.
Oh, the weather outside is bright.
Tickets on sale now through Ticketmaster.com and any Ticketmaster outlet, but we want you to win them right here. Just tune in for your chance to win, brought to you by AM 1220 WQUN and Mohegan Sun. Your time to shine.
Lois Hill reaches back through the centuries to ancient cultures from around the globe, using techniques thousands of years old to create her collection of jewelry now at Jared.
I'm Lois Hill. I've spent years learning ancient jewelry making techniques, techniques that require everything be done by hand, like hand weaving an entire bracelet from a single strand of sterling silver for my bracelets at Jared.
These Lois Hill designs are only at Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry. That's why he went to Jared. Learn more at Jared.com.
It's the Morrow Motors pregame show. Bill Schweitzer with you from the TD Bank Sports Center, and we are chatting with the coach, Tom Moore. You have a Hampton team coming in here. You saw them last year down there in the month of January. It was right before you guys kind of went on that little run that you went on. You lost to them down there. What are you looking for from this team here tonight?
This is a good Hampton team. You know, they'll be one of the best teams in the MEAC, I would assume, this year. Norfolk State's usually pretty good, but the guy, Ed Joyner, has done a really good job down there just sort of piecing this group together. They have about 7 or 8 guys that they can bring off that all have good size and really good athleticism. The two inside guys, Maxwell and Okoroba, are terrific. They're shot blockers at the rim. They're aggressive offensive players, and Hampton does a good job of getting them the most shots. Maxwell's a senior, and Okoroba, I believe, is a junior or a senior. He's an upperclassman, and you know they are hungry offensive and defensive players. I think Ike and Oos and AJ and our whole front court will have their hands full with those guys. But you know, I think our balance is will be good for us. Our guys remember last year's game, and as you alluded to, Bill, we were in a that was probably the lowest point maybe before we had a bunch of things going. going on to us injury-wise. We had illnesses. We had guys foul out. Really a weird rotation and lineup in that particular night. We're down about two or three with inside of 2 or 3 minutes to go in the game and couldn't pull it out. But this will be a challenge and a stiff one because Hampton should have a good team and they should have a good season.
Let's talk about the big guys up front for you. You know, you're looking for consistency. You're looking for guys to do it every single night. It seems like they haven't gotten into that rhythm yet.
No, we haven't gotten Ike and Oos both having good offensive and defensive games yet. Not at all. I thought Ike was particularly bothered by the kid John Puck's size early in the Albany game. I think he got a little frustrated that he got the ball in spots where he normally scores and he didn't. Oos, it's funny, he speaks to his talent. He didn't play a very good low post defensive game at all. I mean, we were really disappointed with how we guarded in the half court, in particular in the middle part of the shot clock and the end of the shot clock. And Oos didn't have a very good game battling for low post defensive position and second effort plays and third effort plays on defense, but yet he gets 18 and 10 because, you know, he's a very talented young guy and he knows how to get baskets off the offensive glass and he cleaned up some stuff that Kaz and Umar and some of those other guys created for him. But yeah, it'd be nice. They're both very dangerous players, and offensively and on the glass, we're continuing to try to develop the pride in their defense that I think has to continue to improve and evolve for us to be a really, really good team.
All right, that's Tom Moore. Stay right where you are. Mike Lyle standing by. He's got a scoreboard update coming your way on the Bobcats Radio Network.
So how's your day going? Is it super full like most days? Could you use a break? How about a coffee break for your soul? A moment to reflect on life. Let me provide that for you at coffeebreakforthesoul.com. You'll receive an inspirational thought that can help put things in perspective. Then journal a thought or two, even share a thought. Subscribe today at coffeebreakforthesoul.com. Be inspired today.
Take a trip down the aisle you'll never forget at Mamma Mia, Broadway's smash hit musical based on the songs of ABBA. Everyone's having the time of their lives at this guaranteed get happy hit about a mother, her daughter, and three possible dads. How can you resist?
See Mamma Mia at the Schubert New Haven, November 22nd through 24th. For tickets, visit Schubert.com. Sponsored by Lexus and Whitney Center.
Hey, it's me, Mike Rowe, here with Fiona Doran, a service advisor to Ford dealership. I've got about 60 seconds today to convince you that Ford is actually in the tire business. I'll be asking the questions. Fiona, she'll be answering them. How are you, Fiona?
Wonderful. How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. Are you ready?
I am.
If I need new tires for my Ford, where should I go?
Your Ford dealership.
And who carries 11 major brands?
Your Ford dealership.
And who's having a big tire event?
Your Ford dealership.
You're basically going to say your Ford dealership no matter what I say, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Nice shoes. Where'd you get those?
Your Ford dealership.
Come see the vehicle experts and get a $70 mail-in rebate when you buy four select tires. Plus another $70 when you use the Ford Service credit card. That's up to $140.
What's capital of Wisconsin?
Your Ford dealership.
That's technically not true.
Subject to credit approval, rebate by check. Other tire manufacturer rebate or offer cannot be combined or Ford Service credit card rebate or offer. See your participating Ford dealer for details through 12/31/13.
And a good evening to you. This is Mike Wild back in the Bobcat Radio Network studios. And this is the Moral Motors pregame scoreboard update. Tonight is a light night for Quinnipiac sports, but the women's basketball team is back in action. And they're set to take on St. John's down New York. You can listen to that game over at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Tip off of that contest at the top of the hour. And a big day tomorrow for the men's soccer team. They're going to be taking on UConn in the opening round of the NCAA tournament up in Storrs. Now, should the Bobcats win that game, they will take on UMBC in the second round of the tournament on Sunday. Taking a look at the MAC Conference scoreboard action tonight, men's hoops action. Only two games on the schedule. Holy Cross versus Fairfield at the top of the hour. And Manhattan pays a visit out to Illinois State for an 8 o'clock tip. On the women's side, we have Manhattan taking on Army at the top of the hour. And Wagner will visit Iona also at the top of the hour. On the college basketball men's top 25 scoreboard tonight, Charleston Southern takes on number 20 Baylor. American visits number 8 Ohio State. Number 14, Wichita State's at Tulsa. And number 21, Iowa State visits BYU. Locally on the NHL scoreboard, the Devils will take on Anaheim out in L.A. at 10 o'clock tonight. On the NBA scoreboard tonight, these are set to tip off in another half hour. The Nets will visit the Bobcats, the Knicks are home to the Pacers, and tonight at 8:30, the Celtics will visit the Spurs. Coming up, the dynamic duo of Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca will have the call as Quinnipiac takes on Hampton from the TD Bank Sports Center right after this.
When your eyes lock in on the all-new CLA's expressive lines and distinct diamond grille, you're not just seeing one of the most expertly designed cars in the world. You're witnessing a breakthrough. Starting at just $29,900, the Mercedes-Benz CLA 250 has completely shattered what's expected from a luxury automobile. With its sporty, state-of-the-art interior, the CLA is a new breed of luxury for a new generation of drivers. The 2014 CLA boasts the superior technology, engineering, and safety you've come to expect from Mercedes-Benz. With a price you never saw coming. Get the 2014 CLA 250 starting at just $29,900.
MSRP for a 2014 CLA 250 excludes all options, taxes, title, registration, transportation charge, and dealer prep. Options, model availability, and actual dealer price may vary. See dealer for details. Some equipment described as optional.
Come test drive yours today at Mercedes-Benz of North Haven, proud sponsors of Quinnipiac Athletics.
See us online at MercedesBenzOfNorthHaven.com.
I wonder how much money he makes. I wonder if he loves his mother. I wonder if he'll lose his hair. I wonder if he wants kids. I wonder if he's the one.
I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max.
Not a chance.
Damn. Wait, for which one?
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Hey, Werner. Catch.
Whoops.
Maybe next time, buddy.
Pepsi Max?
Whoa, Pepsi Max, huh?
All the Pepsi flavor, none of the calories.
What's up, ladies? Can I get some love?
Oh, sweet mother!
Pepsi Max, zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
And welcome back, everybody. Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca from the TD Bank Sports Center, Lender Court. Quinnipiac gets set to go against Hampton. Hampton University, the Pirates out of the MEAC, the Middle Eastern Athletic Conference, and pretty good team, Billy, a team that beat the Bobcats down there last year, but as we heard from Tom Moore, it was right at a point where guys were just starting to come back from injuries, guys were sick, guys had fouled out of that game, and right after that Hampton game, they went on a nice little run and got themselves into the race in the Northeast Conference.
Well, I think that's a good point, and I think as you listen to Tommy talk a little bit about Hampton, he's looking forward as well as the kids on the team to that rematch. Now they got two kids that can really play. You know, they got the kid in the backcourt, Powers, who was an all rookie of the year in the MEAC, and then they got the big kid up front, you know, Maxwell. You know, you got a big kid up front, you got a guy in the backcourt, you got a chance to be pretty good. They're not real deep, and I think it's a game Quinnipiac certainly feels if they perform to the level they're supposed to, it's a team they should be. Interesting thing, conversation I had with Tommy Moore today. And you look at your schedule, and he says, you know, one thing I never understood when I was an assistant at UConn, I really didn't appreciate how good college basketball was. Because when we would play a Quinnipiac, we would play a Fairfield, we would play some of these schools, and we'd win by 25, 35, 40 points. But I didn't have any idea that the guys at this level really do know how to coach and their players really do know how to play. So he goes, I'm getting a rude awakening now. And with the MAC rules as well, you know, you can't play anybody that's ranked RPI below 100. So now you have to be a little more selective in who you want to play. So, you know, he's at, Billy, in the past, I could look at the schedule and say we got, you know, maybe 6, 7, 8 non-conference wins. I'm looking at this thing now and every game's a 50-50 game. So it was probably good perspective for me to hear from Tom, but also for Tom to say,
Yeah, you know, until you figure that out, you don't have a chance.
Yeah, you got to realize, hey, look, we got to work, right?
It ain't falling in your lap, Coach. That's the way this thing works. All right, Bobcats coming off a pretty good one. And again, you know, the backcourt duo, when they're in there together, Umar Shannon and Kasim Chandler, really a nice little blend.
Well, it really is a good little blend. And they can play well together. The question I'm going to ask you now is, you take Quinnipiac's four top players, all right? And I think you would say Umar Shannon. I think you would say Kasim Chandler. Mm-hmm. You say Ike Asitayan, and you would say Usman Jame, right?
Yeah.
Those are Quinnipiac's four worst defenders. Now, you got a guy in Moore who loves to guard. You got four of your best offensive players, your worst defensive players. What happens? My guess is he plays offense, he presses a little more, and I was happy to see that the other day.
Yeah, we haven't seen that during the Tom Moore era a whole lot. We did see it the other day against Albany. All right, stay right where you are. We got the starting lineups coming your way on the Morrow Motors pregame show right after this.
In 400 feet, turn left. Recalculating. In 300 feet, make U-turn. Recalculating. In 200, recalculating. In 50 feet, no 40, no 30. Can you just slow down for a second? Okay, I'm pretty sure you missed that turn on purpose. Recalculating. Hello? Are you even listening to me?
With the BMW X1, there's no predetermined route. You can go anywhere and do anything. And with S-Drive, BMW's dynamic rear-wheel drive system, you can have the performance you expect from a BMW in a sport activity vehicle. Because we only make one thing.
Don't mind me.
The ultimate driving machine. GPS optional equipment.
Test drive the all-new X1 at BMW of North Haven. Proud sponsors of Quinnipiac Athletics. Love my BMW of North Haven.
Yeah, welcome back, everybody. It is the Morrow Motors pregame show. It is Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca at the TD Bank Sports Center. And it is men's basketball. Quinnipiac and Hampton getting set to go. The starting lineups for the Hampton University Pirates out of Hampton, Virginia. They will go with three guards. Deron Powers, 5'11 sophomore out of Williamsburg, Virginia. He was the rookie of the year in the MEAC last year. Keron Brown, a 6'3 sophomore from Savannah, Georgia. And Brian Darden, a 6'2 sophomore from Hampton, Virginia. And along the front line, Devon Maxwell, a 6'7 senior from Manhattan, New York. And Emmanuel Okoroba, 6'8 junior from Garland, Texas. For the Bobcats, three guards, Umar Shannon, the 5'11 grad student out of Atlantic City, New Jersey, by way of St. Francis, Pennsylvania. Zaid Hurst, the 6'4 junior from Bethesda, Maryland. And Shaq Shannon, the 6'1 senior from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And along the front line is Ike Azatam, the 6'7 senior from Boston, Massachusetts. And Usman Drame, the 6'9 junior by way of the Republic of Guinea. Those are the starting lineups. Two teams set to go. That will do it for the Morrow Motors pregame show. Stay right where you are. The opening tip comes your way right after this.
When your eyes lock in on the all-new CLA's expressive lines and distinct diamond grille, you're not just seeing one of the most expertly designed cars in the world. You're witnessing a breakthrough. Starting at just $29,900, the Mercedes-Benz CLA 250 has completely shattered what's expected from a luxury automobile. With its sporty, state-of-the-art interior, the CLA is a new breed of luxury for a new generation of drivers. The 2014 CLA boasts the superior technology, engineering, and safety you've come to expect from Mercedes-Benz, with a price you never saw coming. Get the 2014 CLA 250, starting at just $29,900.
MSRP for a 2014 CLA 250 excludes all options, taxes, title, registration, transportation charge, and dealer prep. Options, model availability, and actual dealer price may vary. See dealer for details. Some equipment described as optional.
Come test drive yours today at Mercedes-Benz of North Haven, proud sponsors of Quinnipiac Athletics.
See us online at MercedesBenzOfNorthHaven.com.
Are you an early bird or a night owl? Well, TD Bank is both. You see, TD Bank is open longer than other banks. They're also open 7 days a week. Of course, you can always visit them online at tdbank.com or give them a ring at 888-751-9000 because you can talk to an actual person 24/7, 365 days a year. It's part of what they call banking human. And it's why TD Bank is America's most convenient bank. Member FDIC, TD Bank N.A.
Get your coffee from the folks that know coffee inside and out. For over 60 years, we've kept America running with our dedication to serving the freshest cup of coffee. Dunkin' Donuts. America runs on Dunkin'. You want your coffee quick, freshly brewed, and ground from only the finest beans. Make the most of your day with the fresh ground taste of America's favorite cup of joe. At Dunkin' Donuts, you can do it. Dunkin' Donuts coffee. America runs on Dunkin'.
Hey, what are you drinking?
I'm drinking Dunkin'. Four mornings a week, I try to get a run in. And I know that I'm supposed to drink a glass of water after my run, but there's the Dunkin' Donuts. right on the way home.
America runs on Dunkin' Coffee.
Hey, what are you drinking?
I'm drinking Dunkin'. When you get that first cup of coffee in the morning, it starts your day off right, you know? Pre-coffee, you should keep your distance. Once I have my Dunkin', I'm all good.
America runs on Dunkin' Coffee.
Quinnipiac basketball exclusively on AM 1220 WQUN Hampton. Ride home with Steve Savino, afternoons from 4 to 6.
How did I get here? Dumb luck? Or good decisions? About marriage, children, money, about tomorrow.
Who matters most to you says the most about you. At MassMutual, we're owned by our policy owners, and they matter most to us. Learn more at massmutual.com/mutuality. Contact us at info@charteroakfinancial.com or visit us at charteroakfinancial.com.
No boards. Shannon has a pick, dribbles, comes off the pick, fires down low to Azatam, and he dunks.
Quinnipiac Bobcats basketball brought to you by TD Bank, America's most convenient bank. By Pepsi, the choice of a new generation. By Dunkin' Donuts, America runs on Dunkin'. By Moro Motors, Mercedes-Benz and BMW of North Haven. By Mass Mutual, they'd like to help you make good financial decisions to protect the people who matter most to you. And by the Beach House Restaurant in Milford. What's not to like? Great food, great staff, super music.
Live from the Lender Court at TD Bank Sports Center in Hampton, Connecticut, it's Quinnipiac University men's basketball. Tonight, the Bobcats take on the Pirates of Hampton University. Hi, everybody. Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca with you as the teams get introduced to the folks here at the bank. And, Billy, pretty good non-conference test for the Bobcats tonight.
Well, it really is, Billy. And, you know, both teams 2-1. And, you know, there's a big difference as a coach if your team is 3-1 versus your team being 2-2. Especially with Quinnipiac now going off on the road up to Maine, which is a tough place to play and really a tough trip. So, you know, I think what you want to see is some carryover. And I think, like you said, Billy, I heard you talk to Tommy in the pregame. You're looking for Quinnipiac now to get that combination, what they're always good at, which is the inside game, that combination of Azatam and Drame to dominate a game. I told you before, those are guys that have only really played 10 minutes a game in the past together. They still need to figure out how to mesh, but it's comforting to know in college basketball you got a backcourt like Umar Shannon, Nickerson Chandler.
You know, with Chandler, here's a guy that is going to penetrate, he's going to make things happen and be able to get the ball to those big guys down there. But you're right, there's only so much space underneath the basket that Ike and Usman have to figure out where that space is for them.
You know, and again, you got to be able to know who's going to stretch it out, who's going to stay, who's going to go, but they both can't sit in that low post. It just doesn't work. But Chandler makes it easy, and I think, Billy, as you know, if Quinnipiac's going to play 94 feet, they're going to be very, very tough to guard.
Yeah, you know, when you see them running up and down the floor, you wonder how our team's going to be able to stop them. But obviously you can't do that every single time, but you want to try and do it as much as you can.
Well, what we saw against Albany after that first 5 minutes, we saw a team that scored 70% of their points in transition, Billy. And in transition, you know there's mismatches, and that's where Quinnipiac shines. In transition, you miss a shot, and the bigs run really well. So I think it's a real good formula for success, and it was well done against Albany.
All right, team's set to go. They're still huddled up around the coaches. Bobcats in their home whites with the dark blue numbers and blue and gold trim. And they will be moving from our right to left here in the first half. Hampton in their road blue uniforms with white numbers and white trim. And waiting for the players to make their way out on the court. Tom Moore getting in some last-minute instruction. And the Hampton guys are still huddled up around their coach as well.
And we haven't talked about Billy, that's really done a pretty good job, is that combination of Zaid Hurst and Evan Conte. The guys that are probably the leading rebounders from that three position. Conte with a big game the other day. Conte, a big game in Philly. And Hurst the other night, Billy, 14 points and 12 rebounds. So they're getting a lot of balls because the bigs are boxing out.
All right, two teams make their way out on the court. Usman Drame will jump it up against Devon Maxwell. Maxwell, leading scorer for this Hampton team. And we are set for some college basketball. Bobcats and Pirates fighting it out here at the Lender Court. Opening tip controlled by the Bobcats. They put the ball in the hands of Shaq Shannon. Shannon into the front court. Man-to-man defense by Hampton. Throws left side for Hurst. Lobs one down low to Azatam. Fakes. Goes to the baseline. To the basket. Reverse layup. No good. And a whistle and the ball knocked out of bounds by Hampton.
Yeah, good start for Azatam, Billy. He takes it down on a post. And I think he didn't need to go underneath the basket and could have laid in with a left, but went real aggressive.
Umar Shannon to inbound. Inbounds it to Shannon. Shaq Shannon along the right sideline. Shannon bounces down low to Drame. Back to the basket. Backs in on Okoroda. To the rim. Goes up. Shot blocked by Maxwell coming over to help out. Maxwell hands off to Powers. Deron Powers into the front court. Gives it along the left sideline. Darden down low to Maxwell. Shovels it underneath to Okoroda. Ball loose on the floor and rolls out of bounds. Last touch by Hampton.
It's taken Quinnipiac, Billy, 10, 12 minutes in every game they've played before they double the post. They immediately double the low post with the opposite big man.
Hampton will put on pressure in the backcourt. Azatam to inbound the ball. Gets it into Umar Shannon. Powers is on him. Shannon throws it up ahead, and Shaq Shannon brings it into the front court, into the lane, bounces down low. Drame, reverse layup is good.
Well, the first thing you want to do against pressure, Willie, is push the ball up the court and get an easy one, and the Bobcats just did.
Powers quickly back the other way, puts up a three. Off the rim, no good. Rebound, Hurst. Zaid Hurst runs it out of the backcourt for the Bobcats to the top of the key, pulls up. Foul line jump. Off the back rim, no good. Rebound, batted around, taken by Hampton. Powers controls, comes out of the backcourt to the basket, driving left-hand shot. Good, and a foul. Umar Shannon called for blocking, and Hampton will try to make it a three-point play.
Well, probably one you want to stay with Shannon underneath the basket that time. Just give the basket up, take it out, and push up the court. And not crazy about Zaid Hurst's shot, Billy, in transition. You know, he didn't really have numbers, and he pulls up from the foul line, and maybe one you want to sneak back out and get it back inside.
Powers' free throw is good. He makes it a three-point play, and Hampton takes a 3-2 lead here in the early going. Pressure in the backcourt, inbounded to Shaq Shannon. Shannon says, clear this backcourt. I'll take it from here. Darden is on him, comes across with the left-hand dribble. Shannon along the left sideline, now comes toward the top of the key, now back along the left. He's guarded by Darden, accelerates to the left baseline, still has it on the floor, 16 on the shot clock. Shannon still dribbles, top of the key, picks up the dribble, now throws right side for Hurst, 9 on the shot clock. Hurst pulls up, the jump, good.
Yeah, it took a while for it to develop, Billy, but Quinnipiac was able to get that 15-foot jumper on a down screen from Hurst on the wing.
4-3, Bobcats in front. We're in the opening minutes. Powers out of the backcourt, gives to Darden along the left sideline for Hampton. Off a pick, top of the key, flips along the left sideline now. And Brown, long jump, no good. It goes off the rim and out of bounds. And let's see. They say the Bobcats touched it last. So Hampton will keep the ball. Into the ball game for Hampton, it'll be Miles Jackson, a 6'5 sophomore out of Silver Spring, Maryland, and he replaces Kieron Brown. Inbound at Darden along the right baseline. Puts up a jump. Off the rim, no good. Rebound, Drame. Drame hands off to Shaq Shannon. Shannon out of the backcourt. Shannon to the top of the key for the Bobcats. Now pulls out. Man-to-man defense by Hampton as Shannon comes along the right sideline. Picks up the dribble. Gets it down low to Drame. Turns. Jumps. Off the rim, no good. Rebound. Taken away by Maxwell. Maxwell grabs it, gets it ahead to Powers. Powers quickly into the front court, down the lane, driving shot, good.
Hey, he's a pretty good player, Billy. You can see why. He was rookie of the year in the conference, was able to generate speed and lay it in with his left hand.
He's got all the Hampton points. 5-4, Hampton in front here in the early going. Hurst, left side of the key, fakes, bounces once, now gets to Umar Shannon out near midcourt. Shannon comes to the right side, has a pick from Azatam, comes to the top of the key, to the lane, shot blocked by Okoroda, but it's recovered by Shaq Shannon. 12 on the shot clock to Umar Shannon. Right baseline, the jump way off the mark. Rebound, Hurst. His shot partially blocked, and rebound, Hampton. They're on the run. Darden to the basket, drives, lays it in, and he's fouled.
Well, Hampton's coming up with their own transition baskets, Billy. If he makes this, that would be 8 points for St. Francis. Hampton in transition. Good looks for Quinnipiac, but they're not getting back on defense.
Shaq Shannon comes out as Evan Conti into the lineup for the first time for the Bobcats. And Brian Darden at the line, and he will try to make this a three-point play. in and out, rebound, knocked out of bounds, and they say last touch by the Bobcats. Hurst had a hand on it and couldn't hold on.
We had a little bit out of sync now for Quinnipiac early in this basketball game. Billy, a little sloppy on offense and defense.
7-4, the lead for Hampton. Three-point shot off the inbounds, no good. Rebound to Hurst. Hurst runs it out of the backcourt. Hurst down the right side, driving shot, no good. Rebound, Conti. He fakes, he goes up with the left, good.
Man, good productive move that time by Conti. As soon as he's in, he boxes man out. Good left-handed lay by Evan.
7-6, Hampton in front. Powers out of the backcourt, gives to Maxwell, top of the key. Flips on the left side now. For Jackson, they swing it to the right. Okoroda into the lane, fakes and travels with the basketball. Also took an elbow from Ike Azatam, but that came after the travel. Oops.
Yeah, accidental elbow that time, yeah. But certainly he knows that Azatam's been spending some time in the weight room, Coach.
Umar Shannon against some mild pressure brings it into the front court for the Bobcats. We play just over 3.5 minutes. Quinnipiac down by 1, 7-6. Azatam crosses over, now flips out top of the key to Conti, throws on the right side for Umar Shannon. Shannon off a pick to the foul line, to the lane, down low to Drame, fakes, up with the shot, no good. Rebound tipped by Azatam, no good. Azatam grabs the rebound and then loses the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, good effort that time by Quinnipiac on the offensive glass, Billy, just a little bit unlucky. Azatam has a tendency on a rebound to put the ball out in front of him, giving the defense a chance to slap it.
Deron Powers out of the backcourt for Hampton. Powers throws top of the key to Maxwell, puts up a jump, good.
Yeah, he shot like that, he knew what he was doing. Close out a little more, make him put the ball on the floor.
9-6, Hampton in front. Maxwell, their leading scorer with his first bucket of the night. Top of the key, Azatam. Thought about a shot, now throws right side for Conti. Bounces it down low to Azatam. He's into the lane, fakes, turnaround, jump, no good, but he's fouled. Devon Maxwell will pick up the foul, and it will put Ike Azatam at the line to shoot a couple, but first we're going to go to a timeout. 15:35 remaining in the first half. It's Hampton 9, Quinnipiac 6. We'll be right back.
Now you can go to the beach any time of the year. At the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut, the Beach House follows their own philosophy of fresh is best, with an exquisite cuisine of natural hormone-free beef, organic chicken, and the freshest of fish. The charming Oak Bar and the Chef's Exhibition Kitchen invite everyone to enjoy the delightful atmosphere and the flirtatious views of the Sound. Come to the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. You never know who may be waiting inside.
Hi, this is Bill Schweitzer. You know, when you can't get to a game, listen on AM 1220 WQUN or on any mobile device by downloading the Quinnipiac Bobcats app and then clicking on radio, or the TuneIn Radio app and search for WQUN. They're both free. And after the game, listen to the Morrow Motors post-game show when you're driving back down the hill. Hear comments from a coach, highlights from the game, and pearls of wisdom from Bill Mecca.
We are back. Mecca and his pearls sitting alongside me. I'm Bill Schweitzer. Bobcats down 9-6 here in the early going. Ike Azatam will be at the free throw line.
You know, Billy, early in the game, you got 5 offensive rebounds for Quinnipiac, and none of those have led to any points. So it's a time in a basketball game where you really just need to slow down. And I talk all the time, you want to be quick, but you don't want to hurry, because hurry puts you in a position where you're rushing shots. And this guy get a little more composed inside, command the ball, chin the ball. When I say chin the ball, put it to your chest, get your elbows wide, and then explode up. So sloppy early, haven't finished plays, but certainly with 12 shots to 8, you think Quinnipiac's a game, should be able to control the backboards.
The thing is, Billy, there's a lot of length on this Hampton team, and it's causing some problems down below.
Well, it really is, as Azatam makes a free throw, you know, and I'm questioning why wouldn't they double Azatam? Why wouldn't they double Drame? Two things. They've never seen Quinnipiac play. They've watched a tape. And second of all, I think you hit it on the head, partner, they're able to block shots. So they're saying, go ahead, take a shot. We're long. We're going to go ahead and knock it off the glass.
Some confusion here as the officials go over to the score table. Not sure what they are discussing over there, but I don't know. They pointed at Azatam as if to say maybe that's not the guy that should be on the free throw line, but I think they will find that out very quickly. Or maybe they are. I'm not sure.
I don't know what they're talking about. I know Eric Eaton's over there talking to the officials and trying to get some sense. It certainly wasn't the jump ball because the arrow should be pointing at Hampton's Way, and that's happening. So I'm not sure on what they're talking about it, but Eaton saw something. And
the discussion continues. They try to keep the coaches away from the scorer's table as the referees discuss it. The officials tonight, Willie Pulliam, Wallace Ritecki, and Kyle Walter. Shaq Shannon trying to check into the game. They aren't paying much attention to him as they continue to talk about whatever the issue is that they are discussing at the table.
Unless they get confused with the Shannons, you know, and the bench seems to think that Shaq Shannon was in the game and not Umar Shannon, and you can't sub after a timeout. So that's the only thing I can think of, trying to see who was in the game or who wasn't in the game. But it's got to be much to do about nothing, Willie. The bottom line is Azatam shooting the free throws.
Well, we got Kasim Chandler out on the floor, and that might be what the discussion is. Because he was not in before the timeout. Well, whatever it was they were discussing, they are satisfied they have everything correct out on the floor. And Ike Azatam has one more free throw coming. Bends the knees, flips with the right hand, and hits. So Azatam makes two. Bobcats are down by one, 9-8. Hampton with the basketball. Deron Powers across midcourt, picked up by Kasim Chandler. Stutter steps, comes to the top of the key, comes to the left side. Chandler stays with him, gives to Brown, top of the key. Kieron Brown back to Powers. Powers calls out a play, comes to the top of the key, fires the jump, no good. Rebound Conti. Evan Conti throws ahead to Chandler. Chandler into the front court, crossover dribble, and he gets bumped, and the foul is called. Kasim Chandler at high speed gets bumped on his way to the basket. It'll be a non-shooting foul, and the Bobcats will inbound the ball.
Hey, you know, Billy, they talk a little bit earlier in this season about they're going to protect the dribbler. And if you have a point guard that's able to penetrate and put pressure on the defense, any contact's going to be a foul, and Chandler does that.
Chandler to inbound, gets it into Umar Shannon in the right corner. Picks up his dribble, gets it down low to Drame. Drame backs in on Okoroba, now flips it back out to Shannon. Back to Drame, into the lane, running jump hook, off the rim, no good. Rebound, Azatam, back up, no good, but he's fouled. So Azatam back to the line, and he will try to give the Bobcats their first lead of the night. They're down by one, 9-8.
Well, that's the most frustrating part of myself now as a former coach and now as an analyst, that when Kasim Chandler took the ball to the basket, Billy, he got touched and they blew the whistle. That time Drame had the ball in the low post, he was not allowed to make a move to his right shoulder as Azatam misses the free throw. He was hit 27 times harder than Chandler was, yet no whistle because they're protecting the dribbler. Well, that time Drame was the dribbler.
Mecca's got that all down on the Richter scale right here in front of him. 27 times. And Azatam misses them both, and Okoroba the rebound for Hampton. 9-8, Hampton in front. We played just over 5 minutes. Bringing it into the front court. Lawrence Cooks. Cooks throws on the right side for Okoroba. Now top of the key, it goes to Darden. Flips on the left side for Brown. Now they swing it to the right for Darden. Down low, Okoroba back to the basket. Backs in on Azatam. Fadeaway jump off the rim. No good. Rebound tipped and taken by Brown. Kieron Brown gets it back out. They get it in the hands of Lawrence Cooks. Top of the key. Now they swing it to the left side. Now top of the key to Brown. Brown gives to Okoroba. Waits. Hands to Cooks coming behind him. Cooks into the lane. Floating shot. No good. Rebound. Azatam, and he's fouled. Cooks tried to reach in and grab it away from Azatam, and he commits the foul.
A good defensive set that time by Quinnipiac. Good strong rebound by Azatam. And I think what I'm interested in trying to see offensively now, some semblance of purpose to Quinnipiac's offense, Billy. 3-for-13 right now from the field, and nobody that seems to be generating any half court.
Bobcats with the ball. They are down by one. Drame along the right baseline, fakes into the lane, has the ball slapped away, dives, gets it out to Chandler. Chandler into the lane, and he is fouled. Okoroba picks up the foul. That's number five on Hampton as a team, first on Okoroba. So non-shooting foul, but only one more before they're over the limit. Chandler looking to inbound, lobs it into Azatam, left side of the key, dribbles, comes to the foul line, now throws right side for Conti. Conti picks up his dribble, gives it off to Chandler. Chandler backs out near midcourt, calls out a play. Lots of time on the shot clock, 24 seconds. Gives to Azatam on the left side. Azatam into the lane, drives, goes up for the shot, and he's fouled before the shot. So they're calling him close. A lot of ticky-tack stuff, but that's going to be team foul number 6 on Hampton.
With a lot of minutes to go in the half. So anytime you put the ball on the floor and you turn your shoulder to the basket, it seems as if they're going to blow the whistle. So one foul now from now, Billy Quinnipiac is going to be able to get some free ones and then maybe able to get this shooting touch back.
That was Dwight McKeel picking up his third already. Lobbed in to Drame out along the right sideline. Waits, hands to Chandler. Chandler dribbles to the top of the key. Now backs out near the circle at midcourt. Cooks on him tightly, crossover dribble to the right side. Down low, Drame goes up, misses the layup. Tip by Azatam, no good. Tip by Drame is good.
Now you're disappointed for Chandler. He made a great feed, doesn't get the assist, but Azatam and Drame clean up inside.
Bobcats with their first lead, 10-9, just over 13 minutes to play in the first half. Okoroba right side, hands to Cooks coming behind him. Now back to Okoroba, but the ball is kicked by the Bobcats and kicked out of bounds. A.J. Sumbrey will check in for the Bobcats, and he will replace Usman Drame. Hampton will inbound the ball with 22 seconds on the shot clock. One-point Bobcat lead. They look. They get it in. Darden to the hoop, goes up for the shot, and a blocking foul called against Conti.
A little fast out-of-bounds play that time by Hampton. Twice we've seen Darden on an out-of-bounds play, Billy, go at a speed that Quinnipiac's not used to guarding. And, you know, when you practice out-of-bounds plays against your own team, you kind of let them do it so the coach gets happy. You don't really guard it. But when you play an opponent and they play at a higher level, you got to remember as he makes the free throw, you got to always be between your man and the ball and move your feet.
Darden's free throw ties the game at 10. He has one more coming. 13 minutes remaining in the first half. Second one spins in and out. Rebound Azatam. So all even at 10 apiece as Kasim Chandler brings it into the front court for the Bobcats. Flips left side for Umar Shannon. Zone defense now by Hampton. To Chandler, top of the key to Shannon on the left. Back to Chandler. Chandler dribbles the ball. 19 on the shot clock gives to Conti, right side. Conti dribbles. Now gives left side for Chandler. To the right for Conti. 10 on the shot clock. Shannon nearly traveled with it, gets it away to Shannon to Chandler. His shot blocked by Okoroba, taken away, throws ahead for Cooks. Cooks into the front court, dashes it into the left corner. Darden for three, and it's good.
Yeah, pretty good transition break that time. You thought Darden was going to go for a two-on-one. Slid out onto the corner, Billy, nobody there. Good transition by Hampton.
13-10, Hampton in front, right to the foul line. Azatam fires it underneath. It's knocked away by Maxwell and out of bounds.
Yeah, zone defense now confused Quinnipiac a little bit, Billy. And I think what the perimeter guys need to do against the zone, obviously, is dribble gaps. It's a wide zone. Dribble gaps and then make the feed.
Chandler to inbound. Hurst and Drame back in as Azatam and Umar Shannon go to the bench. And we have a whistle and a foul. It's going to go against the Bobcats. It'll be A.J. Sumbrey picking up the foul. That's his first. Fourth on the team. So Hampton takes over, and they have a three-point lead as they bring the ball up court. Lawrence Cooks across midcourt, picked up by Chandler. Gives it to a high post to Okoroba. Okoroba throws right side for Cooks. Now top of the key, Darden for three. Off the back rim, no good. Rebound, Drame. Fires ahead for Chandler. Chandler quickly out of the backcourt, crossover into the lane. Tries to get it underneath for Sumbrey, and it's picked off by Hampton. They step right in front. Cooks into the front court, gives it off. Maxwell, here's the jump. Off the back rim, no good. Rebound, Hurst. Zaid Hurst throws ahead for Chandler. Chandler into the front court. And again, throws it away, but knocked down. Chandler picks up the loose ball and lays it in.
Well, good heady play that time by Chandler. Makes a physical mistake, Billy, but mentally stays in it and is able to recover the loose ball. And dipsy-do for two.
Hampton by one, 13-12, with just over 11 minutes to play in the first half. Right side, Kieron Brown swung around, picked off by Chandler, but they said he stepped on the sideline, and that gives it back to Hampton. We have a timeout on the floor, 11 11 remaining in the first half. Hampton 13, Quinnipiac 12 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Live from the TD Bank Sports Center in Hampton.
Step inside the most unique arena in all of college sports for Quinnipiac Bobcats basketball. Take your seat, then leap out of your seat and cheer on the men's and women's teams as they drive to the big dance. It's Major Division I MAC Conference basketball, and you're sitting so close you can see your reflection in the gleaming hardwood. Get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Quinnipiac basketball, the only thing as exciting as the home team is the home court.
Some people build fences to keep people out, and other people build fences to keep people in. Long Wharf Theater presents August Wilson's Fences, directed by Felicia Rashad. Called a dramatic home run by the New York Post, this Pulitzer Prize and Tony Award-winning masterpiece is the theater event not to be missed this year. Get your tickets today for August Wilson's Fences at longwharf.org. Long Wharf Theater. Life on stage.
Well, welcome back, everybody. Bill Schweitzer and Bill Necca from the TD Bank Sports Center. Quinnipiac trailing Hampton by 1, 13-12. Just over 11 minutes to play in the first half.
Well, you guys see with Quinnipiac right now, Billy, 5 for 17 from the field for 29%. I see a team that's not been real efficient. And, you know, like washing your car with just water. You get your hose, you spray your car, and then all of a sudden you say, okay, my car is clean, and you haven't done anything. You got to scrub that thing. And I think now Quinnipiac needs to get some elbow grease on that car and clean it up a little bit. They got to work a lot tighter and a lot cleaner.
Hampton with the basketball, inbounded to Powers, who's back in the ballgame. Deron Powers, their point guard, calls out a play. Kasim Chandler gives him room. Now comes off a pick to the top of the key to Maxwell. Maxwell holds, throws right side for Brown. Brown bounces the ball, comes to the foul line, picks up the dribble into the lane. Okoroba goes up against Azatam, and he's called for traveling.
Well, good defensive set that time. You know, Hampton on the half-court set, Billy, surprisingly, is very patient in a half-court set. They're a pretty well-coached team.
Mm-hmm. Bobcats down by one. Chandler into the front court, gives to Hurst. Now to Drame at a high post. Underneath Azatam. Reverse layup is no good. Rebound knocked to the floor. Knocked out of bounds by Hampton.
Well, you were right, Billy. They're all athletic, and they're long, and they're lean, and they're not afraid to jump. And if you're Quinnipiac post players, my advice is dunk the basketball. They can't block that.
Chandler inbounds into the right corner for Shaq Shannon. Shannon dribbles it out along the sideline. Now comes to the top of the key. Gives to Chandler on the left side. Zone defense by Hampton. They throw right side for Hurst. Shaq Shannon, top of the key, comes to the left side underneath. The Drame goes up. Layup, no good. Rebound tipped, taken by Maxwell. Kicks it out for Cooks. Cooks quickly into the front court, down the lane, driving shot. No good. And rebounded by Shaq Shannon. Fires into the front court for Chandler. Chandler right side, comes to the lane, drops it down low for Drame. Bad pass, and it's picked off by Hampton. Hampton throws ahead. They run up and down. Lob pass for Maxwell under the basket. Gets it, puts it up, and lays it in.
Well, good heady play that time by Maxwell in transition. Goes up, waits for all the Quinnipiac players, and is able to clean it up inside.
Three-point lead. Chandler into the lane, kicks it out. Shannon, Shaq Shannon, gives back to Chandler in the left corner. Back to Shannon, top of the key. Shaq Shannon, left side, Chandler. For three, off the rim, short, rebounded by Brown of Hampton. Fires into the front court for Powers. Powers to the left side, accelerates to the baseline, up for the shot, no good. Tip by Okoroba is good.
Quinnipiac's getting hammered in transition, Billy. Not scoring a lot of baskets and not running back to defend transition.
17-12, Hampton in front. Hurst, left side of the key, gives to Shaq Shannon, top of the key. Shannon picks up his dribble, gives to Azatam, turns at the foul line, his jump way off the mark. Rebound tipped out, taken by Azatam, and then loses the handle. Ball loose on the floor, Okoroba dives for it, up with it, gets the head to Cooks. Cooks into the lane, and he's fouled. Shaq Shannon gets his money's worth as Cooks could not get the shot off, but he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Once Hampton got to six personal fouls, Billy, I think it was probably at the 13-14 minute mark, they went zone, and that zone effectively has shut down Quinnipiac on a half court. And I think that's early in the season. You're not a zone team. You don't have a lot of practice against a zone. And clearly in a half court set, Quinnipiac's not comfortable facing that matchup 2-3.
Cooks makes the first free throw. Miles Jackson in for Hampton. Evan Conti in for the Bobcats. Conti will replace Kasim Chandler. Cooks, one more free throw coming. flips up with the right hand and hits. Hampton with their biggest lead, a 7-point lead at 19-12. Bobcats with the basketball. Umar Shannon back in the lineup, brings the ball up court for the Bobcats, gets to a high post to Drame, faces the basket. Now throws right side for Conti, back top of the key for Umar Shannon. Returns to Conti, right side, bounces down low for Drame, gets to Hurst into the lane, drives and lays it in with the left hand.
Well, good basket that cut that time by Hurst against the zone, Billy. Hard to guard cutters against the zone.
Down low, Okoroba poked away by Hurst, and he steals the ball. Gets it ahead for Shannon. Umar Shannon into the front court, down the right side to the basket, up with the shot, no good. Rebound tip taken by Hampton. Maxwell runs it out of the backcourt, behind the back dribble, right around Conti and lays it in.
How do you do, Maxwell? Behind the back, in transition.
Back the other way come the Bobcats. Ball tipped. Shannon recovers it before it goes into the backcourt. Shannon throws right side for Conti. 25 on the shot clock. Just over 8 minutes to play in the first half. To Azatam, spins into the lane, up with the shot. No good. Boy, a lot of hammering underneath. Mercado takes the ball, goes up court, and gets tripped from behind by Hurst.
Yeah, good spin move that time by Azatam, Billy, against the zone. But, again, I think at times with the post players from Quinnipiac, they're predetermined shots. So as he puts the ball down on the floor and picks up his dribble, he's thinking one thing. His eyes are on the target. Defenders go. They look to block the shot. You can become a passer as a post player.
Keron Brown back in the lineup for Hampton. Deontay Adams in for the first time. Top of the key, Jackson. Miles Jackson throws right side for Brown. Brown holds the ball, watched by Hurst. Now to Mercado, top of the key, bounces one on the left side for Powers. Powers dribbles to the top of the key, gives to Brown on the right side. Back to Powers. And a whistle away from the basketball. The foul is going to go against the Bobcats. Ike Azatam called for the foul. And that will put Bobcats over the limit, and it will bring us to a timeout. 7:46 remaining in the first half. Hampton 21, Quinnipiac 14. We'll be right back.
I wonder how much money he makes. I wonder if he loves his mother. I wonder if he'll lose his hair. I wonder if he wants kids. I wonder if he's the one.
I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max.
Not a chance.
Dang. Wait, for which one?
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Hey, Werner. Catch.
Whoops.
Maybe next time, buddy.
Pepsi Max?
Whoa, Pepsi Max, huh?
All the Pepsi flavor, none of the calories.
What's up, ladies? Can I get some love?
Oh, sweet mother!
Pepsi Max, zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
We are back at the Lender Court at TD Bank Sports Center. Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca with you. Bobcats trail Hampton 21-14. Billy, the shooting way off the mark, 6 of 24. Hampton's got a lot to do with that, with hands in the face. And in addition, they also have 4 blocked shots due to the Pirates.
They've been very active inside, and the shots they haven't blocked, they've contested. So, you know, I think with all the misses for Quinnipiac, you're looking at 2-for-8 for Drame and 2-for-6 for Azatam, you know, Billy, and that has attributed to the length of Hampton. And that doesn't mean you can't play. You just got to play better. And I appreciate what Hampton's doing with their X's and O's, but this game's going to come down to guys named Mike and Joe. I mean, your players got to be better than what they played for Quinnipiac. It's been a poor game of basketball for the first 13 minutes for these Bobcats.
Deontay Adams at the line. He'll shoot 1-1 as the Bobcats have gone over the foul limit here in the first half. 7:46 remaining in the half. Free throw by Adams is good.
Anytime fans come to a game or anytime you're listening to a game, the first time you see a team play, you should be able to recognize who the best players on the court are. And I think if someone's watching Quinnipiac today, I don't think they have any idea who Quinnipiac's best player is because their best aren't playing their best.
Adams makes 2 free throws, and that's the biggest lead of the game for Hampton, 23-14. Hurst, left side, against the zone defense to Shannon, top of the key. Umar Shannon gives on the right side for Conti. Back to Shannon. Bobcats just pass the ball around the perimeter of the zone. Shannon puts it on the floor, now moves forward. 18 on the shot clock. Hooks a pass left side. Hurst. Hurst into the lane. Kicks it out right side. Conti for three. Off the rim. No good. Rebound. Sumbrey comes down to the floor. On the floor. Hands it off to Hurst. Foul line jump. Good.
Well, you know, Hurst is competing, and Hurst is able to go ahead and get a rebound and get a basket.
Powers quickly back the other way. Drives the lane and lays it in. Chandler back in for the Bobcats. He replaces Hurst. 7:05 remaining. 9-point Hampton lead, 25-16. Bobcats out of the backcourt. Conti, top of the key, gives to Azatam. Now throws right side Chandler. Back to Conti. Flips on the left side for Shannon. Bounces down to the left baseline. Azatam hooks a pass cross court to Conti. Conti down low. Sumbrey up with the shot. No good, but he's fouled. So A.J. Sumbrey, the big freshman out of East Windsor, New Jersey, will go to the line, and he'll shoot two.
Well, I like what Quinnipiac did offensively now against his own Billy. They got the ball into the short corner on the left side of the court. You flatten out the defense. Defense has to drop to the level of the basketball, and then you can get a ball reverse and then free up the inside. So a little bit more movement, a little less stationary, and now you get a chance to make some 15-footers from the foul line.
Sumbrey's first is short. So one more for Sumbrey. Zaid Hurst at the scorer's table will replace Sumbrey at the earliest opportunity, but he has one more free throw coming. Bends the knees, flips with the right hand, and hits. So Sumbrey makes one of two. He comes out of the game, Hurst back in, and the Bobcats are down by eight.
Yeah, some full court pressure here, going small with Hurst playing the four.
Inbounded, Powers, he'll go against Shannon and easily comes out of the backcourt. Now accelerates down the left side, pulls out, and comes along the left sideline. Gets it down low for Maxwell, throws cross court. Mercado for three, off the rim, no good. Rebound, saved from going out of bounds by Brown as he fires it all the way out to midcourt. Powers has it into the lane, up with the left, no good. Rebound, Azatam. Up ahead, Shannon. Umar Shannon out of the backcourt, left side. Poked away, stolen by Maxwell. Maxwell comes racing up court with Azatam, goes by him, and dunks with two hands.
Boy, poor man George Gervin there, Billy, in transition, isn't he?
Good hands and a good finish. 10-point Hampton lead, 27-17. Conti along the left sideline in the left corner for Hurst. Has room, doesn't take the shot. Dribbles, now gets to Shannon, top of the key for three. Off the rim, no good. Rebound Azatam at the baseline. Dribbles out of traffic. Gets it down low for Hurst. Back out, Shannon for three is good.
That's one Quinnipiac needed. You needed to make one, Billy. He had missed the first four. Good rebound by Azatam, and Shannon's going to get hot.
27-20, Hampton by seven. Pressure in the backcourt. Pass ahead, Mercado, top of the key. Drives into the lane, to the basket, goes up. Good.
Well, defensively in the transition, Quinnipiac hasn't been really good. Azatam's got to meet the ball handle at that time.
Shannon out of the backcourt. Gives top of the key for Chandler. 5:20 left in the half. Bobcats down by nine. Conti along the right sideline. Directs traffic into the lane. Spins. Picks up. Hooks a pass. And hooks it right in the hands of Mercado. He stepped right in front of Hurst and picks it off. They put it in the hands of Powers. And Powers now slowly into the front court. For Hampton, comes to the left side, now accelerates down the left side to the basket and lays it in.
Good timeout here by Hampton. Good call there by Hampton. He's going ahead and get some substitutes in the game. And Kid Powers is pushing the ball in transition. And Quinnipiac's just backing up, Billy. At some point, you got to meet the guy and stop his direction.
Powers with 9 points. Maxwell with eight leading the charge. And Hampton with their lead, biggest lead of the night, 11 points, 31-20.
I think you hit it on the head. I think you certainly realize who the two best players from Hampton are, and that's Powers and Maxwell. They're standing out as the guys you need to stop, and you still haven't seen anybody for the Bobcats step up and say, don't worry about it. I'm going to take care of this and get us back in the basketball game. So it's a team right now where, Billy, in the game of basketball, you've got to be able to run an individual race. And you see Powers and Maxwell from Hampton running their race, and then collectively the rest of the team is following them. But Quinnipiac, you don't have anybody individually winning their battles, and then collectively you have a team that is trailing Hampton and off to which might be the worst half of basketball we've certainly seen this year.
Bobcats with the ball, 4:57 remaining in the first half. Quinnipiac down by 11. Umar Shannon comes to midcourt. 1-3-1 trap press by Hampton. He gets it to Chandler, back to Shannon. Returns to Chandler, top of the key, fakes a three into the lane. Now dishes back out Hurst. Hurst drives to the top of the key, picks up the dribble, gives to Drame, fakes, goes up. Ball knocked out of his hands and out of bounds. Again, those quick hands of the big guys by Hampton underneath. Okoroba knocks it away.
You got to protect that ball on your hip as you go and finish the play. You can't be careless when you're looking to score.
14 on the shot clock. Chandler looks to inbound, knocked away by Mercado, and they'll throw in again, but now it's 12 seconds on the shot clock. Well, they have a trigger finger on that clock.
Yeah, they're active. They really are. And you said something about their hands, and they do a real good job of moving their arms, which basically creates another defender in terms of how active they are.
Chandler will inbound it from the sideline now, where the ball was knocked out of bounds. Chandler looks, fakes, gets it in. Shannon dribbles the ball, now puts up a three off the front rim. No good. Rebound Azatam, back up, and he's fouled. So Ike Azatam will go to the line, where he is 2 out of 4 so far tonight. Okoroba picks up his second, and Azatam to shoot 2 free throws.
Yeah, you know, Azatam's big, strong. He's a brute in there, and I think he's starting to use his physical body in there to wear Maxwell out. I mean, Maxwell's long and lean, but you got to lean on him a little bit. Get him tired, Billy, and I think Azatam certainly was effective, and now you got to make a count on the foul line.
Azatam takes the ball, bends the knees, flips up with the right hand, and it spins in and out. No good. Deontay Adams checks in, and Okoroba takes his 2 fouls and goes to the bench. So Azatam, 2 of 5 from the line. He's missed his last 3, and he has one more coming. Bends the knees, flips with the right hand, and he hits this one. 10-point Hampton lead, 31-21 with 4:25 left in the half. Lawrence Cooks into the front court, picked up by Chandler. Comes to the top of the key, throws along the right sideline for Adams. Now they swing it left for Mercado, bounces along the left sideline for Brown. Back to Cooks, returns to Brown, puts up a jump, in and out, no good. Rebounded off the floor by Chandler. Chandler runs it into the front court. Chandler, top of the key, pulls up. Here's the jump, way off the mark, rebounded by Mercado. Clanked it off the rim, and Hampton runs it back the other way, ahead to Cooks. Cooks left side, bounces down low to Adams. Faces the basket, kicks it out, right side. Brown, the jump, good.
Well, they're taking advantage of every mistake that Quinnipiac makes, and Quinnipiac's not answering the bell when they need to.
Umar Shannon down the lane. Driving shot, no good, but he's fouled. So Shannon will go to the line to shoot 2. Deontay Adams picks up the foul, and we go to a timeout with 3:40 remaining in the half. Hampton 33, Quinnipiac 21 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Hey, it's Buddy from the all-new Quality Hyundai Superstore. I want to personally invite you to our grand opening celebration, which continues for November, with huge savings on our massive inventory of new Hyundais, all with America's best warranty, 10 years, 100,000 miles, and Hyundai Assurance. During Quality Hyundai's grand opening sale, 2013 Elantras are only $14,848. That's right, less than $15,000 for a new Hyundai Elantra. And right now, you can save $4,000 on 2013 Sonatas. Nothing beats a grand opening sale, and only the all-new Quality Hyundai Superstore has new Elantras for $14,848 and $4,000 savings on 2013 Sonatas. So don't miss our grand opening sale going on right now. We're so easy to get to on the East Haven-New Haven line, right next to CarMax on I-95. And visit us online at myqualityhyundai.com for all the details.
Elantra price includes all available factory rebates, dealer discount of $247 plus tax, registration, and conveyance fee. Sonata savings includes all available rebates.
We're back. It's the TD Bank Sports Center. It's men's basketball, and Quinnipiac down by a dozen here with 3:40 to play in the first half.
Yeah, Quinnipiac's playing offense and defense, Billy, like they got an ear infection. And, you know, when you got an ear infection, your head gets stuffy and you get dizzy, and your equilibrium goes off. And clearly, watching this Quinnipiac team, they're not sharp, they're not efficient, they're not fighting with heart, desire, determination. I don't see all those gifts that made them so special against Albany, against LaSalle. So a little penicillin in the locker room at halftime, clear up that infection and get ready for the second half. But down 12, Billy, you want to try to get this to 6 or 8. You got to make a little run here in the next 3 to go in the locker room with some confidence.
Umar Shannon at the line. He'll shoot two free throws for the Bobcats. First is up. It's good. Shannon with 4 points on the evening. Has one more free throw coming. Bends the knees, flips with the right hand, and hits. So two free throws by Umar Shannon make it a 10-point ball game. Hampton leads it 33-23. Powers out of the backcourt for Hampton. Gives to a high post to Adams. Now hands to Mercado coming behind him. Mercado tries to bounce it down low, kicked away. No whistle. Comes back to Hampton. Adams into the lane. Turnaround jump is good.
Man, they're making plays. You know, Hampton's shooting 50% from the field. Good little spin in the lane to score.
Hurst left side, along the left sideline, gets it down low to Azatam against the zone, kicks it right side, Chandler for three, no good, rebound, Hurst, and he lays it in.
Well, he's been Quinnipiac's best player, Billy, again, he continues to do ordinary things in an extraordinary way. Good offensive rebound, it gives him eight.
35-25, though, Bobcats are down by 10 with under 3 minutes to play in the half. Top of the key, Cooks, and a whistle away from the ball. And Deontay Adams picks up a foul for an illegal pick and gives it over to the Bobcats.
Well, time to build here now, Billy. I'm going to go ahead and you'll be able to get one and get the shot you want. The zone has been very effective for Hampton ever since Coach went to it when they had six personal fouls.
Shannon out of the backcourt against the zone, flips left side for Hurst. 2:45 left in the half, throws right side now for Conti. Conti dribbles along the sideline, bounces to a high post to Azatam, fakes down the right side, up with the shot. Good as he banks it in. Quickly back the other way, Powers into the lane, drops it down low for Maxwell. He's double-teamed, gets it away. Mercado along the baseline, reverse layup, no good, but it's blocked out of bounds by the Bobcats. Drame blocked it, and it goes out of bounds.
Well, that's one you got to come up with, really, right? The guy's on the baseline underneath the basket. Quinnipiac's got to make a push in the stand.
Inbounded, 24 on the shot clock. Left side, Cooks comes to the left baseline. Now comes back out again. Gives to Powers, and Powers calls out a play. 15 on the shot clock for Hampton. Powers bounces it down low to Maxwell into the lane. Jumps a pass down low, tip, but recovered by Hampton to Mercado for three. No good. Rebound Hurst. Hurst races out of the backcourt. Hurst to the right side, hands off to Umar Shannon. Shannon dribbles out, comes out to the circle at midcourt. Shannon directs traffic from there. Has a pick. Off the pick to the left side. Picks up the dribble, gives left corner for Conti. Gets it down low to Drame. Drame double team, spins away from it, goes up for the shot, and he's fouled. So with a minute 43 remaining, Bobcats down by 8. Usman Drame will go to the line to shoot two.
That was a pretty good heady play that time by Shannon, Billy. He wanted to get it to Drame, couldn't, threw the ball to the corner and a real good post feed by Conti. Now, that's going to be the second foul on Maxwell, and clearly he'll come out now to not pick up the third, and I wouldn't mind playing against Hampton if Maxwell was on the bench.
Drame's first, up with the left hand. It's good. Maxwell does come out, and it'll be Miles Jackson into the lineup. Also, Mercado is out, and Brian Darden back in for Hampton.
Yeah, sometimes as a coach, we get smarter than we really need to be. You don't wonder why Hampton decides to go man when they've been so effective in their zone defense.
Missed free throw, rebound, knocked to the floor, but Azatam can't keep it from going out of bounds. He and the ball went hurtling out.
Yeah, 3 years ago, you could have called a timeout, but the powers to be changed, which was the worst rule in the game.
7-point Hampton lead with a minute 35 remaining in the half. Jackson throws the ball to Cooks. Comes off a pick down the right side to the basket. Shot blocked by Azatam. Taken off by Conti. Conti runs it up court for the Bobcats. Comes to the right side. Jumps a pass. Left corner, Hurst. Hurst puts it on the floor. Now gets back to Conti. Conti to the lane. Pulls up the jump. Good.
Real good job by Conti. He just had so much energy to the team. And real good composure offensively. Good efficient play by Conti.
Bobcats get a 12-point Hampton lead down to 5 with a minute 5 left in the half. Powell along the left sideline. Comes off a pick, top of the key. Now kicks it out right side. Jackson for 3. Good as he banks it in. I didn't hear him call bank, Billy.
Boy, that might have been the ugliest shot I think I've ever seen. A timeout here by Quinnipiac. And I think it's a good timeout by Tommy Moore, because your team made a run. And the last thing you want to do when they make a lucky shot and you're a little discouraged is tell your team, Don't be frustrated. Let's keep on playing at this level, and let's finish this half off.
So 51 seconds remaining in the half, and the Bobcats now down by 8. They had cut it to 5, but a brick thrown up by Jackson banks in off the backboard.
Yeah, we're in a perfect shot place to watch. You know, he's out there on the wing, and he shoots the ball, and basically we can see a direct line to the basket. There's no chance of things going in. We're looking for a long rebound, and you're like, oh, my goodness, OMG, it hits the side and goes in. So I like the timeout by Tommy, and he's going to be able to gather his team and say, hey, let's get one. Let's get to the locker room regardless what the score is. And they've learned they need to get Maxwell out of the game.
So the Bobcats come out with Umar Shannon, Zaid Hurst, Evan Conti, along with Drame and Azatam. Hurst will inbound the basketball. Inbounds it to Shannon. Zone defense by the Pirates. They get it into the left corner to Hurst. Hurst holds, now gives it to Azatam in the lane. Fakes up with the jump. Good as he banks it in.
That was a great timeout by Coach Moore. Able to get a timeout, get inside to Azatam. Without Maxwell in the game, you can play against Hampton.
6-point game now with under 30 seconds to play in the half. Powers will hold it. Just about a 1 second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Powers comes to the circle at midcourt, comes forward with Umar Shannon watching him. 16 on the game clock, 13 on the shot clock. Continues to dribble. Now under 10 on the shot clock, comes to the left side, picked up by Drame and a switch, goes to the basket, blocked by Drame and out of bounds. 2 seconds on the shot clock for Hampton, 4 seconds on the game clock.
Well, it's imperative here, Billy, that Quinnipiac plays this clock through, not just for two. They got to play it for three and clear this rebound. Hampton's been very quick out of bounds.
They look, they get it inbounded to Darden, forces a shot, no good, at the buzzer. Shot clock violation. It did not hit the rim. So with 1.5 seconds left, the Bobcats will try to get one up court in a hurry.
No, Billy, quite honestly, it was 4 on the clock. It should be 2.
Should be, but it's Quinnipiac's guys on the clock, Billy. What can I tell you? And Hampton will pressure Azatam, gets the ball in. Shannon fires way off the mark from three-quarters court. So the Bobcats, who were down by 12 at one point in the half, are down by 6 as we go to halftime.
Good little run there by Quinnipiac at the end of the half, and probably for that minute and 27 seconds, the Bobcats looked like a team that we saw play before. Crowd got in it a little bit, and give them some life as you head into the locker room. Curious to see as you get into the locker room, and we'll talk to the coaches after the game, is it a half where the coach massages or the coach is a little more demanding? They got to play better, bottom line.
Well, they do have to play better, and we'll see what they come out like to start the second half. We are at intermission. Bobcats down by 6 as we go to break. We'll be back right after this.
How did I get here? Dumb luck or good decisions? About marriage, children, money, about tomorrow.
Who matters most to you says the most about you. At MassMutual, we're owned by our policy owners, and they matter most to us. Learn more at massmutual.com/mutuality. Contact us at info@charteroakfinancial.com or visit us at charteroakfinancial.com.
Get your coffee from the folks that know coffee, inside and out. For over 60 years, we've kept America running with our dedication to serving the freshest cup of coffee. Dunkin' Donuts. America runs on Dunkin'. You want your coffee quick, freshly brewed, and ground from only the finest beans. Make the most of your day with the fresh ground taste of America's favorite cup of joe. At Dunkin' Donuts, you can do it. Dunkin' Donuts coffee. America runs on Dunkin'.
Hey, what are you drinking?
I'm drinking Dunkin'. 4 mornings a week, I try to get a run in. And I know that I'm supposed to drink a glass of water after my run, but there's the Dunkin' Donuts. Right on the way home.
America runs on Dunkin' Coffee.
Hey, what are you drinking?
I'm drinking Dunkin'. Where do you get that first cup of coffee in the morning? It starts your day off right, you know? Pre-coffee, you should keep your distance. Once I have my Dunkin', I'm all good.
America runs on Dunkin' Coffee.
And welcome back, everybody. Bill Schweitzer, Bill Mecca. We are at the TD Bank Sports Center. Bobcats down by 6 at halftime. Of course, they take the score off the scoreboard at halftime when that is where we get our score from. And so I know they're down by 6, Billy.
38-32, Hampton at the half, Billy. I was able to look at the stat monitor, and it wasn't because I knew what the score was. I just knew I could look at the stat monitor.
Sometimes that's correct, sometimes it's not. All right, we've got a guest at halftime, and it's his university, so he comes on with us anytime he would like. Takes a sip of water, takes his time, gets into the seat. He'll get the headset on and joining us here at courtside, the president of Quinnipiac University, Dr. John Leahy. John, this is really an exciting time. We get on and we talk a lot of stuff about Quinnipiac when you're on, but we're going to talk athletics. I mean, athletics is really burning it up these days. You got field hockey going to the NCAAs, men's soccer going to the NCAAs. Both hockey teams ranked in the top 5 in the country. This is a good time to be a Bobcat.
Not surprising, is it?
That's what we're supposed
to
be,
I told you guys, right? No, it really is. Yeah, to be in the new conference, the MAC, and right out of the gate to win two conference championships in field hockey and in men's soccer, and you said to play in the NCAA against we play American, now we're playing UConn. And,
UConn tomorrow night.
You said the hockey programs, you know, they were talking about us last year, both men's and women's, and it's obviously we weren't a flash in the pan. We're right back in the top 10 and very competitive, and I'm excited about the basketball team as well. I think the men's, I saw the second half of Albany played very well. I mentioned that to Scotty Burrell, and he said, it's good you didn't see the first half. I guess we didn't play quite as well, but... And we didn't play, you know, this is a pretty good Hampton team. They played pretty tough, but, you know, that zone defense, I'm not sure. I'm sure they're working on that at halftime. But,
yeah, we'll make some adjustments.
I think to be within 6, you know, we got some shoes. Exciting, too. It's a fun game. And the women, I just got the score there at St. John's. They're down by 9 at the half, 36-27, but Trish got another great year. So, no, you're right. This year may be the year of all of our athletic programs. They're really going to have a great year.
Well, you know, Billy, you've been here a long time as well as I have, and I know John's been with us 27 years.
He's been here. Oh, no, he hasn't been here longer than you. He's been here longer than me.
Well, and I think the key with what you did, and it's really interesting, was the sense that you knew athletics at some point was going to become something very important to this institution. But that wasn't the first thing you worried about when you got here, when you built an institution. You had a plan, but your plan started with the academic reputation of Quinnipiac.
Oh, no question, Bill. I mean, we've been Division I, what, 12 years or something now? So it was 15 years of preparation for that. And, you know, you want to make sure that, you know, first and foremost, let's face it, we're educating young people to have careers, to be important citizens, and to be family people and so on. So it's not even close. I know you're athletic guys, and I like athletics, but, I mean, that's what we're doing. That's our most important responsibility. But there's no question, once your academic programs get well known, yes, you can get known in the academic circles through faculty and other things. There's nothing like athletics to get the word out about your institution. Right. With television, radio, you guys know it. I don't have to mention the schools that literally have made their name. And I've also watched, though, there are some schools that have gotten it backwards and attempted to get known for athletics first without having the academic program. And there tends to be a strong tendency and a temptation there to cut corners and to not do things right. You know, I told all my coaches, I said, look, I'd love for you to win. I'd love for the students, for the athletes to win. But I said, listen, break no rules. Don't hurt the reputation of this institution. Far and away more important. And I don't take it for granted. I've seen enough scandals and problems elsewhere. I am so proud of our athletic program and the start with Jack McDonald and Bill Mecker and all the coaches. They said, you know, they're all hungry to win, but, you know, they're obeying the rules, behaving correctly, and the athletes are well-behaved outside, and when they're not, they're quickly disciplined and the message goes out.
You know, really, they have gotten the message, the coaches, the players. I get to travel with these guys. I'm on the road with basketball players, hockey players, and I'll tell you what, they really represent the university very well on the road.
No, and I make sure I tell them that when I see them, you know. I try to pump them up, you know, good luck with a great game, but, you know, the two things I always say, I said, hit those books as hard as you hit those boards. And I tell them how proud I really am the way they represent it. And, you know, college athletics these days, you know, the media tends to play up the bad, apples in the bunch. Overwhelming majority of college athletes, men and women, are just great young people. that you'd be proud to have at your, your son or daughter. And I must say, in the case of Quinnipiac, I couldn't be prouder of how they represent us.
No question.
Hey, the amazing thing here is, I walk around and I really do know everybody. And then when I go to a hockey game and John comes down from the hockey from upstairs in his suite and he walks down, and guys and gals that particularly want to take a picture with him. So it's a guy that's part, you really are part of the university, Johnny. You're not one of those presidents who just kind of hangs out and no one sees him. You know the students know who you are.
I think those pictures have to do more with the cell phones. They all have, students didn't used to carry a camera around, right? When they go to a basketball event. They all have cell phones now. So it's a picture generation. You're right. As you say, I'm up there in my suite and entertaining people we hopefully can get big gifts for the future of the university. But I make a point of getting down into the where the student section is. And the last two times I've been in hockey, we've scored a goal. So I'm going to make a habit out of that. I'll tell you, there's no more exciting place at Quinnipiac than being down in that student section when a hockey goal is scored. It's pretty electrifying.
Raise the roof off the place. John, as always, thank you so much for stopping by. It's always a pleasure.
Great. Thanks for all the work you guys do.
Thanks for joining us, John.
Appreciate the Bill and Bill Show.
All right. That is the president of Quinnipiac University, Dr. John Leahy, as the Bobcats trail Hampton at halftime by the score of 38-32. Mike Lyle standing by. He'll have a scoreboard update coming your way on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Hello, I'm Kyle DeLucia, owner of K&J Tree Removal. In the past, we have been inundated with high winds, ice, and snowstorms that have caused damage to trees, homes, and power lines. Be prepared before the next storm strikes. K&J can remove, prune, and even cable your trees. K&J is currently running a special, $600 off any tree job. Call K&J Tree Removal at 203-248-TREE. That's 203-248-8733. Or visit us on the web at kjtreeremoval.com.
Hey, it's Buddy from the all-new Quality Hyundai Superstore. I want to personally invite you to our grand opening celebration, which continues for November, with huge savings on our massive inventory of new Hyundais, all with America's best warranty, 10 years, 100,000 miles, and Hyundai Assurance. During Quality Hyundai's grand opening sale, 2013 Elantras are only $14,848. That's right, less than $15,000 for a new Hyundai Elantra. And right now, you can save $4,000 on 2013 Sonatas. Nothing beats a grand opening sale, and only the all-new Quality Hyundai Superstore has new Elantras for $14,848 and $4,000 savings on 2013 Sonatas. So don't miss our grand opening sale going on right now. We're so easy to get to on the East Haven-New Haven line, right next to CarMax on I-95. And visit us online at myqualityhyundai.com for all the details.
Elantra price includes all available factory rebates, dealer discount of $247 plus tax, registration, and conveyance fee. Sonata savings includes all available rebates.
So, how's your day going? Is it super full like most days? Could you use a break? How about a coffee break for your soul? A moment to reflect on life. Let me provide that for you at coffeebreakforthesoul.com. You'll receive an inspirational thought that can help put things in perspective. Then journal a thought or two, even share a thought. Subscribe today at coffeebreakforthesoul.com. Be inspired today.
All right, this is Mike Lau back in the Bobcat Radio Network studios, and this is the halftime scoreboard update. Other Quinnipiac sports tonight, the women's basketball team is taking on St. John's down in New York, and they're at the half with the Lady Bobcats trailing right now 36-27. Meanwhile, a big day tomorrow for the men's soccer team. The 2013 MAC champs are set to begin play in the opening round of the NCAA tournament with a matchup against UConn up in Storrs. Now, should the Bobcats win, they will take on UMBC in the second round on Sunday. Take a look at the MAC Men's Conference scoreboard, a couple of games right now. Holy Cross leads Fairfield 29-22 at the break, and at the top of the hour, it will be Manhattan taking on Illinois State. One women's conference game in the MAC, this is at the half, Iona leads Wagner by a score of 38-26. On the men's top 25 scoreboard, number 20 Baylor leads Charleston Southern 31-28. Early first half, American leads number 8 Ohio State 11-10. And these are late games. Number 14 Wichita State's at Tulsa, and number 21 Iowa State visits BYU. Locally on the NHL scoreboard, the Devils will visit Anaheim tonight at 10 o'clock. On the NBA scoreboard locally, these are all second quarter scores. The Bobcats lead the Nets 40-37, and the Knicks hold a 1-point lead over the Pacers 24-23. At 8:30, it'll be the Celtics taking on the Spurs. Coming up, Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca will have second half action as Quinnipiac trails 38-32 against Hampton. We head back to the bank right after this.
I wonder how much money he makes. I wonder if he loves his mother. I wonder if he'll lose his hair. I wonder if he wants kids. I wonder if he's the one.
I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max.
Not a chance.
Damn. Wait, for which one?
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Hey, Werner. Catch.
Whoops.
Maybe next time, buddy.
Pepsi Max?
Whoa. Pepsi Max, huh?
All the Pepsi flavor, none of the calories.
What's up, ladies? Can I get some love?
Oh, sweet mother!
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Quinnipiac basketball exclusively on AM 1220 WQUN Hamden. Drive to work with Ray Andrewson, mornings from 6 to 10.
Now you can go to the beach any time of the year. At the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut, the Beach House follows their own philosophy of fresh is best, with an exquisite cuisine of natural hormone-free beef, organic chicken, and the freshest of fish. The charming Oak Bar and the Chef's Exhibition Kitchen invite everyone to enjoy the delightful atmosphere and the flirtatious views of the Sound. Come to the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. You never know who may be waiting inside.
Are you an early bird or a night owl? Well, TD Bank is both. You see, TD Bank is open longer than other banks. That means mighty early and mighty late. Of course, you can always visit them online at tdbank.com or give them a ring at 888-751-9000. Because you can talk to an actual person 24/7, 365 days a year. It's part of what they call banking human. And it's why TD Bank is America's most convenient bank. Member FDIC, TD Bank N.A.
And welcome back, everybody. Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca with you. Second half about to get underway. Quinnipiac trailing Hampton 38-32 as we are about to start the second half. Got some numbers for us?
Well, I got some numbers that I think are disappointing, and they're more team numbers, Billy. You know, you're looking at the shooting for Quinnipiac, 12-35, and a couple of those 12s were the last 2 minutes of the half, you know. So they haven't shot it real well, only 34%. 1-for-6 from threes against a team that's zoning. The big thing for me, Billy, is 13 offensive rebounds for Quinnipiac. And only 10 points, and that's a possible 26 points. So they really haven't been efficient, and I would say it's a team that honestly, instead of playing carefree, has played careless. 8 turnovers to 7 assists. They just need to play better, and nothing out there on these stats would give you any sense that Quinnipiac has a chance to win, except they just need to play better. Hirsch has been pretty special, and you need to get the backcourt to contribute.
All right, Hampton will have the ball to start the second half for the Bobcats. Shaq Shannon, Zaid Hurst, Umar Shannon, Usman Drame, and Ike Azatam. Same team that started the game on the floor for the Bobcats. Second half underway. Powers to the top of the key for Hampton. Bounces down low to Okoroba. Okoroba guarded by Azatam. Up with the jump hook. Off the rim. No good. Rebound Drame. Kicks it out to Shaq Shannon. Shannon out of the backcourt to the right side. Accelerates into the lane. Shot blocked. And the ball loose and now picked up by Maxwell. Throws it ahead for Brown. Keyron Brown to the basket, blocked by Drame, but the ball goes out of bounds, and Hampton will hold on to it.
Well, Billy, you saw two things now that stood out. You get a block shot by Shaq Shannon, but a clear rebound and finish by Hampton. Block shot by Quinnipiac, Hampton gets another chance. You got to come up with loose balls.
Inbound to Darden along the left sideline, gets it out to the top of the key. Powers. Powers throws on the left side for Okoroba. Now they swing it to the right side. Brown to Powers into the lane. Drops a pass on the give and go, and the drive by Maxwell is good.
Well, he's been pretty good. He's really long, Billy, and pretty good explosion to the basket.
Hurst back the other way. Bobcats trail 40-32. Azatam into the lane. Drops it down low to Drame. Poked loose. Now the ball into the corner, picked up by Azatam, up with the shot, off the rim, no good. Rebound is tipped and taken by Darden of Hampton. Races out of the backcourt, has numbers, bounces down low. Maxwell, and he lays it in.
Big guys run real well for Hampton, Billy. They're all about the same size, and they've really hurt Quinnipiac in transition.
They have the lead back up to 10, 42-32. Shannon comes along the left sideline for the Bobcats, looking for their first points of the second half. We played a minute and a half of the second half. Right side, Umar Shannon, the jump, no good. Rebound, foul. Drame came down with the rebound, but they said he pushed off to get it. So he commits the foul, and Hampton takes over in the backcourt.
Yeah, it's a little sloppy down there, even on the offensive end. You get a rebound by Drame, you really don't need to hold the defender. You're 6'9", you jump real well. Jump with two hands and clear the ball.
Hampton brings it across midcourt. Bobcats are down by 10 here in the early going of the second half. Keron Brown throws right side Darden, bounces it down low to Okoroda. He fakes, goes up for the shot, and travels with the ball. So that turns it back over to the Bobcats. We're nearly 2 minutes into the second half. Quinnipiac looking for their first points of the second half. Shaq Shannon brings it up.
It's tough as a coach when you don't really have any guy to go to make a play for you. No one has stood out for Quinnipiac.
Hurst to the left side, gets it down low to Azatam, spins to the lane, ball knocked loose by Okoroba and picked up by Brown. Brown races into the front court, pulls up right side, now gives the ball to Powers. Powers stutter steps, gets it down low, Maxwell, turnaround jump, off the rim, no good, rebound, Shaq Shannon. Shannon brings it out of the backcourt to the top of the key, pulls up, throws right side, Umar Shannon for three, off the rim, no good, rebound, Zaid Hurst. And let's see, the foul is going to be called on Hampton. And I think it's Maxwell just from the body language. No, it's not. It'll be Deron Powers picking up the foul. So it'll be a non-shooting foul. Powers stays on the floor. Brown comes out. And Hurst will inbound the ball from the baseline. Looks. Gets it into Azatam at the right baseline. Kicks it out. Drame out at the top of the key. Holds the ball. Bounces once, hands to Hurst coming behind him, puts up a three, it's no good. Rebound tip taken by Shaq Shannon, goes up all in one motion and gets fouled. And Powers picks up another quick foul.
Well, you get Powers and you get Maxwell out of the game, then I like your chances for Quinnipiac, but they're the glue that keeps Hampton together, and it's going to be an ugly game for Quinnipiac. It's going to be one that's not going to be free-flowing, and it's going to be very similar to when we make those real dumb decisions at the dentist, when he says, look, you just got a little cavity. You want Novocaine or can you handle the pain? And as Shannon shoots the free throw and misses, you say, yeah, don't worry about it, Doc. Just take care of it with no Novocaine. And this is what Quinnipiac looks like tonight. They look like they're getting their cavities filled without Novocaine. It's painful, but it still can be effective.
I was wondering where you're going.
Effective.
Two and a half from into the second half. Shannon makes the second free throw. That's his first point of the night. Bobcats are down by 9, 42-33. Lawrence Cooks into the ball game for Powers, who went to the bench with three fouls. Darden now top of the key. They give it on the right side for Cooks, flips left side for Jackson. Miles Jackson bounces once, gives it to Cooks. Gets it down low, Okoroba. Fakes the shot, now puts it up over Azatam and hits.
You got to contest the shot, Ike. You just can't let him rock you there and just shoot a wide open 12-footer on the game of horse.
44-33, an 11-point Hampton lead. Just under 17 minutes to play. Shaq Shannon along the left sideline. Gives it top of the key to Hurst. Hurst puts it on the floor. Still dribbles. Now gives right side for Shannon. Lobs it down low for Drame. Drame pulls up for a jump. Spins in and out. Rebound knocked out of bounds by Hampton.
Basketball is a game of acting and reacting. Actors win, reactors get beat. And that time, Drame settled for a 17-footer because the defense backed off. I mean, you can't settle against a team like Hampton. Take what you want.
Hurst to inbound from the baseline. Gets it in Drame right side. Now throws to Shaq Shannon, top of the key. Shannon dribbles the ball. Now throws left side for Hurst. Hurst on the move into the lane. Pulls up, gets it out. Umar Shannon for three. Short. Rebounded off the floor by Darden. He outraced the Bobcats to the ball, now races into the front court, stripped away by Shaq Shannon, and the ball recovered by Zaid Hurst. Hurst runs into the front court for the Bobcats, gets it down low for Drame and throws it out of bounds, but they said it was tipped out by Hampton.
Well, great individual effort that time by Hurst, but Billy, quite honestly, he should have thrown the ball a lot sooner than he threw the ball ahead of the pack. You had three defenders behind Zaid, throw the ball ahead, and honestly, you're running a 4-on-2 fast break.
Evan Conte jumps off the bench for the Bobcats, and he will replace Shaq Shannon. 16 minutes, 13 seconds remaining. Bobcats down by 11. Conti to inbound the ball from the baseline. Inbound it to Shannon, right corner. Lobs it down low to Drame. Drame spins and a whistle and a foul. And it's going to go against Hampton. And it's going to go against Okorobo.
But that was a point of emphasis here, partner, in the sense that they weren't going to let big guys flop. And we saw all last year guys just falling and the referees going for the fake. So the officials know now when somebody falls in the post, it's going to be a foul on the defender.
So that takes Okorobo out of the game. Deontay Adams back in for Hampton. Inbound to Shannon, right corner. Lobs it down low to Drame. Backs in on Adams, up with the shot blocked by Maxwell and taken away by Hampton. Maxwell came out of nowhere. Darden gives off to Cooks. Cooks looks to make a move, cut off by Conti. Now bounces down low to Adams. Fakes, up with the shot, fouled from behind. It'll be Usman Drame committing the foul from behind, and it will put Adams at the line to shoot two. We go to a timeout, though, 15:49 remaining. Hampton 44, Quinnipiac 33. We'll be right back.
Now you can go to the beach any time of the year at the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. The Beach House follows their own philosophy of fresh is best, with an exquisite cuisine of natural hormone-free beef, organic chicken, and the freshest of fish. The charming Oak Bar and the Chef's Exhibition Kitchen invite everyone to enjoy the delightful atmosphere and the flirtatious views of the Sound. Come to the Beach House in Milford, Connecticut. You never know who may be waiting inside.
Hi, this is Bill Schweitzer. You know, when you can't get to a game, listen on AM 1220 WQUN or on any mobile device by downloading the Quinnipiac Bobcats app and then clicking on radio, or the TuneIn Radio app and search for WQUN. They're both free. And after the game, listen to the Morrow Motors post-game show when you're driving back down the hill. Hear comments from a coach, highlights from the game, and pearls of wisdom from Bill Mecca.
TD Bank Sports Center, 15:49 remaining. Quinnipiac trailing Hampton 44-33, and so in the first 4 minutes and change of this second half, Billy, the Bobcats have a grand total of 1 point.
And 0 for 8 from the field, Billy, 0 for 3 from threes. They made one free throw attempt, and it just got the makings of one of those games where you just don't seem to have it for Quinnipiac, and you're going to take one of those players out there, Billy, that's going to go have to end up being a star for Quinnipiac and put the team on their back and play the role of superhero.
Deontay Adams will go to the free throw line for Hampton to shoot two. So Hampton up by 11 already with two foul shots coming by Adams. Flips up the first and it rolls in and out.
You know, it's a young season and it's a young team, and the backcourt is young, the new players, and what I sense is now is you sense some frustration by the Quinnipiac basketball players about the results, and they haven't shot it real well, and this is where the gift of heart, determination, and desire needs to step up for Quinnipiac.
Second free throw is good by Adams. So he makes one of two. Bobcats are down by a dozen. Hampton matching their biggest lead of the game. They press in the backcourt. Chandler gets it ahead for Conti, still in the backcourt. Now brings it across with a right-hand dribble. Waits, hands to Chandler coming behind him. Kasim Chandler to the top of the key, throws right side for Conti. Conti dribbles the ball. Man-to-man defense by Hampton. Conti throws left side, Chandler into the lane. Drops a pass out to Hurst for three. Good.
I let Hurst run with the ball a little bit, Billy. Good feed that time by Chandler and a little dish, driving dish, and let Hurst make some plays.
9 point Hampton lead. Maxwell top of the key, puts up a long jump. It's off the rim, no good. Rebounded though by Hampton. Adams gets it back out. Brown top of the key. Now they put it in the hand of Cooks. Lawrence Cooks holds the ball, looks over at the bench and gets a play. Now he directs traffic, gives it right side for Adams. Back to Cooks on the left side. Down the left side, up for the shot, no good. But he is bumped by Chandler, and Kasim Chandler picks up the foul.
As they ran a set play that time, Billy, you didn't see, as the little guy took it to the basket, you didn't see Quinnipiac bigs, you know, A.J. Sumbry and Usman Drame, go over and try to contest that shot, and he cleared out the whole side, and you put Chandler on an island all by himself.
So Lawrence Cooks at the line. He'll shoot a couple of free throws. He has 2 points in the game, and both of them from the free throw line back in the first half. First one is up. It's off the front rim. No good. 9 point Hampton lead, 45 to 36, with just under 15 minutes to play.
Now, you like to think the law of averages will catch up to a team, and Quinnipiac is certainly going to end up shooting the ball better than their current 29%, but I would suggest that now's a good time to change those averages.
Chandler out of the backcourt. Bobcats down by 10. Chandler into the lane. His pass knocked away and stolen. They're trying to force it through. And again, Hampton with another steal in the lane. Brown out of the backcourt. Waits. Now hands off to Cooks. Cooks guarded by Chandler. Directs traffic. Throws along the right sideline for Brown. Keron Brown gives it top of the key to Adams. He puts up a long jump off the rim. No good. Rebound Conte. Conte will run it out of the backcourt. Conte stutter steps down the left side, gives it back. Chandler, top of the key, fakes a three. Now backs out near the circle at midcourt. Comes forward again, throws to Conte. Conte dribbles to the top of the key. Conte throws right side for Hurst. Hurst along the right sideline, looks to make a move, pulls back the jump. Good, a three-pointer by Hurst.
Well, he might be the guy, huh, to put the cape on. He might be the only guy that's going to be able to get Quinnipiac to cut this thing and wake up his other starters.
7 point lead for Hampton as Hurst now with back-to-back threes has 14 points on the night. Down the right side, Cooks pulls up in the lane, the jump, good.
Well, just a little easy every time Hampton seems to want to make a play or get a shot, they make the play.
They stop play.
Why? Why would they stop play so we could talk to their coach?
I have no idea. The Bobcats are dribbling the ball up court. The Hampton coach is in the ear of the referee. He blows the whistle and stops the play. Now let's see what's going on here.
Look, they called a technical foul. Well, how could he call a technical foul when he just listened to the guy from Hampton? They're going to go to the video monitor, Billy, because I think their coach...
Ooh, Devon Maxwell and A.J. Sumbry pick up fouls on the play.
Well, that helps Quinnipiac, doesn't
it?
Oh,
that helps big time for Quinnipiac because Maxwell now has three, right?
This will be Maxwell's third, and clearly he's their best player. So, I mean, he's long and he's lean, and he's got some George Gervin blood in him, Billy. He's a pretty good player, so that's going to help the Bobcats. But I didn't see the call. It wasn't like I saw anything, and it wasn't until the coach from Hampton called the official over that they turned and he blew the whistle and sent both teams to the bench.
And they continue to sort things out. They're looking at the video monitor across the way from us. Okoroba, who has three fouls on him, comes off the bench and he will check in. Maxwell will sit down. Also, Dwight McKeel into the ballgame. He has three fouls as well for Hampton.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised here, Billy. They're going to talk to both coaches. But you're going to see Hampton turn around and get back into their zone defense. And Quinnipiac honestly has got to turn around and make some shots.
It'll be Bobcat ball when they get everything straightened out. Mecca urges on the Bobcats as they come out onto the floor. Conte will inbound the ball from right in front of us. Gets it into Umar Shannon in the backcourt, and he brings it across the line. Left side for Hurst as he makes a move. He is held by Brown, and Keron Brown picks up the foul.
I see the worm starting to turn a little bit here, Billy, and Quinnipiac starting to get a little more aggressive. And Quinnipiac has been the reactor this whole game. They've got to turn this thing around and start throwing some body blows.
Non-shooting foul inbounded. Umar Shannon throws right side for Conte. Dribbles the ball along the right sideline, picks up, gives to Hurst, right side of the key. Now flips left side for Shannon. Gets it down low to Azatam. Backs in, into the lane, fakes, up with the left hand, off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Hampton. McKeel with the rebound, and he double dribbles. He bounced it once, looked for somebody, and then bounced it again. So he hands it back over to the Bobcats with 13:08 remaining. Quinnipiac down by nine. Inbounded to Shannon. Omar Shannon throws left side for Hurst. Now top of the key for Drame for the jump. Off the back rim, no good. Long rebound taken by Hurst. Hurst tries to dribble through a double team, and he's fouled. Lawrence Cooks picks up the foul. And that is team foul number six on Hampton. So one more, and they're over the limit.
Very similar to the first half, Billy. Hampton picked up six through the first 7 minutes of the first half and then went zone and didn't pick up their foul for another 8 minutes.
Inbound to the Azatam left corner. Hands to Hurst coming behind him. Now they swing it to the top of the key to Shannon. Umar Shannon comes to the right side. Has a pick. Off the pick. Skirts down the right side with it. Picks up. Gives top of the key to Conti. Conti into the lane. Pull up. Jump. Good.
Yeah, you get the guys that played a lot of minutes for Quinnipiac, the two juniors. I'm Billy. We talked about Hurst and Conti being productive, and now they're starting to score. Good move by Conti.
7-point Hampton lead with 12 and a half minutes remaining. Right side it goes for Price. Price gets it cross court to Cooks. Now top of the key for Brown. Brown bounces down low to Okoroba. Fakes on Drame. Spins on Drame. Fadeaway jump way off the mark, and the rebound knocked out of bounds by Hampton.
Hampton have a hard time playing offense with Maxwell not in the game, don't they, Billy?
They do. So Bobcat ball down by seven. They've trailed by as many as a dozen in this game. Pass into the front court to Conti. Gets it back to Shannon. Umar Shannon calls out a play. Gives it to a high post to Azatam. Drops it left corner. Hurst for three. Good.
Yeah, the crowd woke up, right? They went zone, Billy. Real good feed that time by Azatam from the post to the corner at Z for three.
And the Bobcats, closest that they've been since way back in the first half. It's a four-point game, and Hampton wants a timeout. 11:48 remaining. It's Hampton 48, Quinnipiac 44.
Yeah, all too often you hear people say, you know, you hear players, you hear coaches saying it was a dead crowd, and the crowd wasn't into the game. And my response to that always is, give somebody something to cheer about. I mean, because people in general in today's society aren't going to cheer until they're happy. Give them something to smile about, be happy, and you heard the three from Z. Everybody wants this team to do good, but they want to watch them play good, and they finally saw something that resembled real good basketball.
Yeah, Zaid Hurst with his third three of this second half. He's got 17 points to lead the Bobcats back into this game.
Yeah, you thought it was going to take someone that was going to go ahead and be a superhero, and they needed someone to put the mask on, put the cape on, and say, I'll put you on my back for a little while. Now what they need to do is continue to get the legions of superheroes to wake and to arise and to get Drame and Azatam to go in with their powers and become effective.
So both teams still huddled up around their coaches. Timeout by Hampton to try and stop the bleeding here. They've led by as many as 12 points. The Bobcats have chopped it down to four thanks to three three-point field goals by Zaid Hurst here in the second half.
Well, they found a guy who was hot, and they found a guy to give him some life. And now it's time for Quinnipiac to settle down. And, Billy, this is probably with the most important defensive stop so far that you need here from Quinnipiac.
Inbounded. Powers back in. Gives it to Okoroba left side. Now top of the key for Mercado. Mercado throws on the right side for Brown. Now to Powers. Powers slices into the lane. Driving shot. No good, but he's fouled. Let's see who picks this one up for the Bobcats. It's going to be Usman Drame. Before we shoot free throws, we're going to go to a timeout with 11:34 remaining. Hampton 48, Quinnipiac 44 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Live from the TD Bank Sports Center in Hampton.
Step inside the most unique arena in all of college sports for Quinnipiac Bobcats basketball. Take your seat, then leap out of your seat and cheer on the men's and women's teams as they drive to the big dance. It's Major Division I MAC Conference basketball, and you're sitting so close you can see your reflection in the gleaming hardwood. Get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Quinnipiac basketball, the only thing as exciting as the home team is the home court.
Take a trip down the aisle you'll never forget at Mamma Mia, Broadway's smash hit musical based on the songs of ABBA. Everyone's having the time of their lives at this guaranteed get happy hit about a mother, her daughter, and three possible dads. How can you resist?
See Mamma Mia at the Schubert New Haven, November 22nd through 24th. For tickets, visit Schubert.com. Sponsored by Lexus and Whitney Center.
And welcome back. Bill Schweitzer and Bill Mecca with you. Men's basketball here at the TD Bank Sports Center. Quinnipiac trailing Hampton 48-44 with 11 and a half minutes remaining. And women's basketball tonight down at St. John's in New York City. The Bobcats are trailing the Red Storm 61-44 in the second half.
Well, you know, St. John's won a little payback on that game last year at TD Bank Sports Center when St. John's had a lead and Quinnipiac came back and won it. So Quinnipiac struggling in the sense they're not winning the games they think they should win, but certainly it's a team that's going to be ready and primed when they get into conference play. Real tough non-conference schedule.
Deron Powers at the line. He'll shoot two for Hampton here. They lead by four with 11 and a half minutes remaining in the game. First free throw by Powers is good. He had 9 first half points. That's his first point of the second half.
Well, he needs to be able to be the guy to go ahead and steady the tide until Maxwell gets back in the basketball game.
Second free throw is good. So two foul shots by Powers. The lead is 6 for Hampton. Conte into the front court. Comes to the right sideline. Man-to-man defense by Hampton. He accelerates into the lane. Tries to go to the basketball. Stripped away and stolen. And then stolen back by Azatam. And as he goes up for a shot, he's fouled. And Okoroba will pick up number 4 for Hampton.
Yeah, a lot of game left, and they're running thin. They're going to go ahead and get their star back in the game, Maxwell. And Quinnipiac's got to continue to throw the ball inside. And I think Quinnipiac now has a chance playing a little bit out of control. Billy, he really wants to make something happen. I think he's frustrated with his numbers. But he needs to take a deep breath, slow down, let the game come to him a little bit.
Wet spot on the floor being mopped up very nicely by one of the Bobcat guys, Shane Doyle.
Well, they're looking at the monitor again now, Billy, and I'm not sure what they're looking at. And I think if you're Quinnipiac now, I wasn't crazy about the play Evan Conte made because I think he forced the action. But come to think of it, I don't mind because I think he's being active and he's making the defense react. He put the pressure on them. Sloppy play, but Quinnipiac comes up with the ball and they're starting to throw some body punches and getting this team into foul trouble, which is going to help them down the stretch.
Two shots for Azatam. That was what the question was. Was he fouled in the act or was he fouled before the shot?
And they had to go
so
to the
it would
monitor.
Have been 1 and 1 or 2. He's shooting 2.
And they had to go to the monitor as he makes a free throw to check that out.
Apparently. They like monitors.
Wow.
Azatam hits on the first. Has one more coming. Bobcats down by 5. 11:20 remaining. Devon Maxwell back in. The top player for this Hampton team. He's got a dozen points on the night. Playing with 3 fouls, but he's back in the lineup as Okoroba goes to the bench with 4. And a lane violation. He missed the free throw, but it wouldn't have counted if it went in. They said Drame was in the lane too quickly.
As a coach, those are the things you're disappointed in. You could control how smart your team plays, and that just wasn't a smart play.
11:20 remaining in the ball game. 5-point Hampton lead. Powers along the right sideline accelerates to the foul line. Still has it on the floor. Nearly throws it away. McKeel recovers, gives back to Powers left side. Powers along the left sideline. Now comes to the top of the key to the foul line. Pull up jump. Short. Rebound. Tip taken by Drame. Drame waits, hands it to Conte, and Conte will run it into the front court for the Bobcats. Under 11 minutes to play, Conte picks up his dribble, gives to Umar Shannon along the right sideline. Shannon puts the ball on the floor, Powers watches him, comes off a pick, puts up a 3, off the mark, no good. Rebound, Hurst has it knocked out of his hands, and they say last touch by the Bobcats.
Real good effort that time by Hurst on the offensive glass, Billy, really elevated. But then when he elevated, he put it on the floor and it went off his foot, so tough break.
Hampton ball, 5-point lead for the Pirates. Powers gives it top of the key to McKeel, and he throws along the right sideline for Mercado. Now to Brown, top of the key, fakes a three, gives the Powers along the left sideline. 10-20 remaining in the game, 5-point Hampton lead. Pass down low and the jump hook by McKeel, no good, and rebounded by Hurst. Kicks it out for Umar Shannon. Shannon quickly into the front court, comes to the right side. Now dribbles to the top of the key, gives to Hurst on the left sideline. Down low to Azatam. Backs in on Maxwell. Loses the handle, ball loose, picked up by Drame at the left baseline. Drame along the baseline, has it slapped loose, recovers, back up. No good, but he's fouled. Sloppy, helter-skelter basketball, but the Bobcats will end up with free throws.
Well, that's not even organized confusion for Quinnipiac on that set. You know, you can't put the ball on the floor until you recognize where the defense is. And Azatam put it on the floor, and really, honestly, there were eight arms coming after him. Four times two is eight with bodies, and then he's on the ground, and then Drame does the same thing. I mean, reverse the ball, have some composure, and I haven't seen a real sense of composure on this Quinnipiac team tonight.
First by Drame is no good. I believe that was Maxwell that picked that one up. He goes off the floor. Yep, that's number four on Devon Maxwell. Deontay Adams into the lineup for Hampton.
Well, that's good news for Quinnipiac. You take their best out, and you still got to get some guys besides Hurst, Billy, in the flow offensively, and you haven't got it tonight from Drame or Azatam.
Second by Drame is good. He makes one of two. Bobcats are down by four as Powers comes into the front court for Hampton. Powers comes out near the circle at midcourt, moves along the right sideline. Now Stutter steps to the top of the key. Hurst is on him, hands it off. McKeel puts up a three off the back rim, no good. Rebound, foul. It's Azatam going over the back, committing the foul.
I don't know. Like, I can't explain to me why a guy would have you boxed out on the defensive boards. I mean, you need to be in front of him, and then you need to jump. I mean, it looked like he was playing for the other team.
Kasim Chandler is in. He'll replace Evan Conte with 9:37 remaining in the game. It'll be Deontay Adams at the line to shoot for Hampton.
Man, it's not a one-on-one yet, so they shouldn't be shooting. It was only a sixth personal foul, so no idea what these guys are looking at.
Yep. And they finally get their attention, and it is not a shooting foul. From here on out, they will be, but this is a non-shooting, and Hampton will inbound the ball from the baseline. Darden lobs it in. They get it to Powers along the right sideline. Back to Darden. Darden fakes, gets it down low to Adams. Backs in on Azatam. Fakes. Up with the fadeaway. Good. And a foul on the rebound. The basket's going to count. And the foul is going to be called as they scrambled for the rebound. And it's going to be Umar Shannon picking up the foul. That puts the Bobcats over the limit. And it will put Ramon Mercado at the line to shoot one and one. And Hampton can make this a four-point play.
Well, a real good offensive play by Adams that time on a punch out. But no reason to blow the whistle there, Billy. Had nothing to do with the game of basketball. The ball was already in the basket. Both guys were going at each other. And they always catch a second one, don't they, Willie?
That appears to be it. Mercado's free throw is good. So Mercado with one more. Flips up with the left hand and hits. So it does become a four-point play. And it gives Hampton an eight-point lead. Bobcats with the ball. They're down 54-46. Chandler into the front court for Quinnipiac. Bounces to the right side for Shannon. Shannon guarded tightly by Darden. Backs out, now gives the ball to Chandler into the lane, hands it off underneath Drama, and he dunks with two hands.
Yeah, that's what the post players need to do. You need to dunk the ball inside. They're not going to foul you because they don't have anybody in there that's tall to foul you. So you get a couple stops down here, you'll be all right.
Powers quickly out of the backcourt. They give it left side for Brown. Keyron Brown throws to Darden, top of the key. Now they put it in the hands of Powers, right sideline to the basket. Drives, gets it down low for Adams, who shot no good, gets his own rebound and lays it in.
Oh, wow, that's disappointing.
Bobcats back the other way. Hurst goes to the left baseline, and he's fouled. So Hampton over the limit, and Zaid Hurst will go to the line, and he'll shoot one and one.
Man, I'm waiting to get to the time in this game where Quinnipiac gets a sense of urgency on the defensive end, Willie, where they put their hands on the ground and say, look, let's commit ourselves as a group to play real good team defense. If a guy beats you, don't worry about it. I got you back. And that hasn't happened today.
No, not at all. So Hurst to shoot one and one. First one is up and in and out. No good. Rebound knocked out of bounds by Hampton. So the Bobcats get a break. They'll hold on to the ball.
Yeah, good strong effort there by Drame, but you know, Billy, like I say all the time, you want to get a rebound. Rebound the ball with two hands.
Inbounded. Shannon gets it down low to Drame, backs in, spins to the baseline, and he gets hammered. Dwight McKeel picks up the foul.
Hampton foul number 23, Dwight McKeel, his fourth personal foul, team's 10th.
That's number four on McKeel.
They're not going to have many guys left inside, are they, Willie?
No. And that also puts Hampton over the 10-foul limit, so Drame will shoot two.
Oh, no, they got the blood rule here, Willie, which means Drame either needs to come out of the game or he needs to get himself taped up so he can shoot the free throws.
Anybody on the bench can shoot free throws?
I think the coach gets an opportunity, the opposing coach.
Coach to pick somebody,
gets
yeah.
to pick somebody, so.
Well, Drame goes over. He gets 10-2 by Semi Abreu, the athletic trainer for the Bobcats, and he'll probably get him back in enough time for Drame to be able to take these foul shots.
I mean, you're at a point in the game now, Billy, where I think it's time that every possession becomes important and every possession becomes critical. And you got to man up here if you're Quinnipiac. You got to man up on the defensive end and you got to man up on the offensive end. And I think you need to go ahead and play with the single purpose of winning this basketball game. But it has to come collectively from five guys, and we haven't seen that A, B, C, D, E connection yet from the Bobcats.
8 minutes and 31 seconds remaining. It's Hampton 56, Quinnipiac 48, and Usman Drame will be at the line to shoot two for Quinnipiac.
The opportunities are going to present themselves for you here down the stretch, and two free throws the rest of the way on every shot for Quinnipiac, and it's not a time where you shoot 50% from the line. You need to make points up. You need to make them up on the line.
First by Drame is good.
Well done by the big fella.
Drame with 9 points on the evening, and he has one more coming. Second, no good. Rebound Hurst. Hurst dribbles it out of traffic, gets it out to Umar Shannon, throws top of the key to Chandler. Chandler into the lane, driving shot, no good, but he's fouled. So Kasim Chandler will go to the line to try his hand at a couple of free throws.
I'm surprised, Billy, that Hampton got out of the zone. I'm happy they did, because Quinnipiac now is going to really be able to slow the game down and gain points without the clock running, and you're going to be able to get back into this game. He must have got scared when Hurst knocked down that big three when Quinnipiac looked organized on the offensive end.
So Kasim Chandler, the freshman, at the line. First free throw is up, and this one is good. 6-point Hampton lead, and Chandler with one more foul shot.
Well, tonight Chandler looks like a freshman.
Second. Off the rim, no good. Bobcats making 1 of 2 from the line. That is not helping them get back. 6-point Hampton lead. Powers out of the backcourt for the Pirates. Comes to the top of the key. Whistle away from the ball. It's going to go against Hampton. Okoroba, and I believe he has just fouled out. So the big guy, Manny Okoroba, fouls out. He'll go to the bench. And popping on in will be Dwight McKeel, who is playing with 4 fouls. Just over 8 minutes to play. Chandler out of the backcourt. Hands to Umar Shannon. Shannon holds the ball. Guarded by Darden. Throws right side for Chandler. Crossover dribble into the lane. Lobs it down low. Ball tipped away and stolen by Hampton. Powers races out of the backcourt into the lane. Driving shot. No good, but he's fouled. So Bobcats careless with the basketball, and now Powers will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Before we do that, we're going to go to a timeout with 7:54 to play. Hampton 56, Quinnipiac 50. We'll be right back.
I wonder how much money he makes. I wonder if he loves his mother. I wonder if he loses hair. I wonder if he wants kids. I wonder if he's the one.
I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max. I want a Pepsi Max.
Not a chance.
Damn.
Wait, for which one?
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Hey, Werner. Catch.
Whoops. Maybe next time, buddy.
Pepsi Max?
Whoa. Pepsi Max, huh?
All the Pepsi flavor, none of the calories.
What's up, lady? Can I get some love?
Oh, sweet mother!
Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Under 8 minutes to play. Bobcats are down by six, and they have been fighting the uphill fight all night long, Billy.
Well, they have, Billy, and again, you look at their top four players. We talked about their most talented guys. You got Azatan 2 for 8. You got Umar Shannon 1 for 10. So that's 3 for 18. You throw Drame 3 for 12. So that's 6 for 30. And then you turn around and you put Kasim Chandler 1 for 5, Billy. So there's 7 for 45 with their stars. And remember, those aren't your best defensive players. So they didn't give it to you in the offensive end, and they not capable of giving it to you on the defensive end.
All right, Mr. Lyle back in the studio. Give me that score again. We got a women's. Wow. So the Bobcats, a couple of minutes to go, have made a run late in the game at St. John's. Red Storm leading Quinnipiac 68-60.
Yeah, good little run there by Quinnipiac. And that goes back to a team that's, they know they're good, and they know they've been there. And the challenge you have is for them not to play in spurts, but to play for the full 40.
Powers makes both free throws, and it's an 8-point lead for Hampton. 7:50 remaining in the game as Umar Shannon comes into the front court, gives to Hurst left side. Holds it high, now gets it down low to Azatam, faces the basket. Azatam fakes to the baseline, shot blocked by McKeel. Loose on the floor, picked up by Azatam, and as he goes to the basket, he's fouled. I believe it's Kieron Brown picking up the foul. And that will put Azatam at the line to shoot two for the Bobcats. But, Billy, they've been to the line now three straight times to shoot two, and they've only made one out of two each time.
Well, Billy, it's a team right now, Quinnipiac, shooting 12 for 22 from the foul line, Willie. That's 54%, and certainly not good enough in a game where you're struggling on the offensive end. You need to have something as he misses the free throw, something to go to. And right now, Quinnipiac is giving away opportunities from the line. It's going to really hurt them when you get to the final 2 or 3 minutes.
Azatam with one more coming. Bends the knees, flips with the right hand, misses. And a whistle and a foul. Lane violation. No, it's not a foul. It's a lane violation by Hampton. So Azatam will get one more shot at it. Bobcats down by 8. Free throw is up. This one's good. 9 points for Azatam, but the Bobcats down by 7, 58-51. Deron Powers out of the backcourt. Comes along the left sideline for Hampton. Gets it to Cook, stop it. A key whistle away from the ball, and it's going to go against Quinnipiac. Mike Azatam away from the ball commits the foul. Both teams over the limit, and it will put Dwight McKeel at the line to shoot 1 and 1.
Yeah, I don't know what they saw that time, Willie. I mean, the guy had nothing to do with the play. I don't mind guys getting fouled when they're dribbling the basketball, but when they're cutters, I don't get it.
McKeel misses. Drame rebounds. Hands to Conte. Conte out of the backcourt for the Bobcats. Comes to the left side. Now back to the top. The key throws right side for Shannon. Umar Shannon holds the ball. Gives to Conte along the right sideline. And a whistle and a foul. McKeel draped all over Usman Drame, and Dwight McKeel picks up the foul. I believe that's number 5 for him.
You know, Billy, what I would really like to do once is sit down with some players, you know, even our guys, and when they're complaining they don't make fouls, sit down and watch the tape to them and then ask him, dude, was that a foul? And they're going to say, yes, it was. I didn't realize that I was mugging the guy.
So McKeel fouls out, and that will bring in Philip Reed, a 6'10 freshman out of Oxnard, California. And Drame at the line for 2 shots with the Bobcats trailing by 7. First is up. It is good.
We need something good to happen here now for your Bobcat fan. You need Drame to make this free throw. And then you need to build from here on in.
Second is up. Good. So Drame makes a couple. Gets the cheer from the crowd. 58-53, a five-point lead for Hampton with just over 7 minutes to play. Powers across midcourt, picked up by Hurst. Throws on the left side for Cooks. Now top of the key, Darden for three. It's good.
Well, really late on that closeout that time by Umar Shannon, Billy. I don't think he thought he was going to shoot it, but they've been taking what the defense gives them.
Eight-point lead for Hampton, 6:50 remaining. Hurst for three. In and out, no good. Rebound, Drame, and a whistle, and it's going to go against the Bobcats. That foul will put Quinnipiac over the 10-foul limit, and it's going to put Philip Reed at the line to shoot two for Hampton.
Did they call that on who's there, Willie?
They did. Six minutes and 46 seconds remaining. First by Reed is good. Kasim Chandler back in. He's going to replace Drame. So Tom Moore is going to go small here. He's got Hurst, Umar Shannon, Conti, Chandler, and Azatam on the floor.
Well, trying to get a little more movement and try to get a little more space inside for Azatam to get open a little bit and move the other post player away.
And Reed makes two free throws. Kieron Brown back in, and Reed goes to the bench, so Hampton goes small as well. Kasim Chandler up court for the Bobcats. Throws it left side, nearly threw it away. Shannon recovers along the sideline. Umar Shannon dribbles the ball. Darden is on him. Stutter steps down to the baseline. Puts up the shot off the rim. Good. It bounced in. Shannon was sitting on the floor watching it go in.
I think that was a tip by Zaid Hurst. Oh, okay. Somehow with his left arm, Billy was able to make a play.
We'll see who they give it to. Might be nice to put a score up on the board, but 6:10 remaining. Darden throws right side for Brown. Now hands it off Powers along the right sideline. Powers dribbles the ball. Stutter steps down the right side, up, crashes into Hurst, and an offensive foul is called.
And Hurst has been really good, Billy. He's been the one guy for Quinnipiac that's go ahead and played a real solid game offensively and making plays on the defensive end. So, you know, Quinnipiac's going to get an opportunity now to get back in this basketball game. And
damn, what's the score?
I can't tell you, Coach, because the board went down, and I think it's 63-57, Bobcats.
This losing. Is just not acceptable. Chandler down the lane, floating shot, rolls around, rolls in. So Chandler with the bucket. Bobcats try and close in here. And a whistle and a timeout by Hampton. 5:38 left, and the Bobcats chipping away.
They're chipping away, Billy, and it's one of those games where you're just playing, like on the playgrounds, baby.
Keep talking. I'll be right
back.
You have
one of those games where you're just playing on the playground, and you're not really sure what the score is, but you know you're just playing, and the scoreboards are down, and the stat monitors are down, so we can't tell you the score, except right now it's got to be a five-point game, I'm guessing, right now for Hampton. They're taking a timeout, and you got to play like you do on the playgrounds right now. May the best team win. Just battling the scoreboard will take care of itself. I always told my team that. Don't pay attention to the scoreboard. Just play the game out and then look at the scoreboard when the game's over. Play hard, play smart.
63-57, Hampton in front.
All righty, a six-point game.
Guess we'll have to keep score here, huh? Hampton with the basketball. They inbound it after the timeout. Powers brings it across the line in along the left sideline. Gets it out top of the key for Adams. Adams hands to Cooks coming behind him. Cooks bounces one left side to Powers. Gets it down low. Maxwell back in the game. Forces the shot. No good. Rebound batted around. Picked up by Hurst. Hurst into the front court. Hurst down the lane. Driving shot. No good. Tip by Azatam, no good. Rebound battled for and taken by Powers. Powers back the other way, fires it up ahead to Maxwell, ahead of the field, and lays it in.
He's clean. Every chance he's got, he's made to play. He's back in the game with four personal fouls. And, you know, if you're Quinnipiac, you really got to pound the ball to him and see if he can pick up his fifth.
65-57, Hampton in front, and Chandler loses the handle as he dribbles in the lane and turns it over.
Chandler just having one of them games, just one of those games where, you know, as a young freshman, he's lit and he's just not making plays for Quinnipiac.
4:50 left, 65-57, Bobcats trail. Darden gives it to Cook, stop the key, flips on the left side, Powers, bounces down low to Maxwell, into the lane, running hook, spins in and out, no good, rebound Conti. Conti dribbles it up court, 4.5 minutes left, right side, Hurst for three, good!
Yeah, maybe could have been a four-point play there, Billy. He got knocked down, but thank goodness Hurst decided to show up tonight.
65-60, Bobcats within five. 4 minutes and 20 seconds remaining. Adams gives right side now for Cooks. Holds the ball, gets it down low to Adams, kicks it out, top of the key, Darden for three. Off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Shaq Shannon. Shannon races out of the backcourt, comes to the left side.
No.
Whistle, foul. And it's going to go against the Bobcats. Nice acting job by, I think it was Powers, who caught a breeze and fell down, and the official calls the foul on the Bobcats. Shannon goes to the bench. And Umar Shannon back in the lineup. 4:04 remaining, 65-60. Hampton in front. Cooks bounces on the right side for Adams, gives it top of the key to Darden. He throws on the left side for Powers. Powers dribbles, gives off to Cooks. Now they bounce it down low to Maxwell. Jumps a pass, left side Powers, hands it off Adams. Stripped of the ball, knocked out of bounds by Hampton. We have a timeout on the floor. 3:40 remaining. Hampton 65, Quinnipiac 60 on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Live from the TD Bank Sports Center in Hampton.
Step inside the most unique arena in all of college sports for Quinnipiac Bobcats basketball. Take your seat, then leap out of your seat and cheer on the men's and women's teams as they drive to the big dance. It's Major Division I MAC Conference basketball, and you're sitting so close you can see your reflection in the gleaming hardwood. Get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Quinnipiac basketball, the only thing as exciting as the home team is the home court.
Hello, I'm Kyle DeLucia, owner of K&J Tree Removal. In the past, we have been inundated with high winds, ice, and snowstorms that have caused damage to trees, homes, and power lines. Be prepared before the next storm strikes. K&J can remove, prune, and even cable your trees. K&J is currently running a special. $600 off any tree job. Call K&J Tree Removal at 203-248-TREE. That's 203-248-8733. Or visit us on the web at kjtreeremoval.com.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. Bill Schweitzer, Bill Mecca with you. Right here, we've got 3:40 remaining. Men's basketball, Quinnipiac trailing Hampton 65-60. And meanwhile, in women's basketball, it's over at St. John's. The Red Storm beats Quinnipiac 76-66.
All right, Billy, got 3:40 to go. Bobcats down two possessions, 65-60. And I think as a coach, we get tempted now to continue to get the ball inside to our big guys so they can make a play. Now, they haven't been productive, so I'm going to try to think about getting it to my big guys, but I want them to be my passers. And I think you got to get the ball to the guy who's been the most effective player for you and your best player. Give Hurst an opportunity to make a shot.
Umar Shannon brings it up court. 3:35 remaining. Met by Cooks at the top of the key. Shannon comes to the left side. Still dribbling the basketball. Still has it on the floor. Top of the key, 20 on the shot clock. Comes to the left side. Has a pick from Azatam. Off the pick, stumbles. Now puts up a three. Good!
Well, I had no interest in what the Bobcats were doing offensively until Shannon shot the ball. Then I liked the result.
65-63. Bobcats within two with just over 3 minutes remaining. Left side, Darden. Gives it top of the key to Cooks. Cooks calls out a play. Comes off a pick. Right side accelerates down the right side. Shot blocked, but a whistle and a foul. Drame blocked the shot, but before the block, it was Shannon, Umar Shannon, picking up the foul.
Well, so,
Lawrence Cooks to shoot two.
Well, the good news for Quinnipiac is they haven't exerted a lot of energy on the defensive end. So they're going to have a lot in the tank. And you saw Drame come out of nowhere, Billy, that time when the guard turned the corner and blocked that shot. He misses the free throw. So, hey, they're not tired.
They are not. Cooks with one more free throw coming. Flips up with the right hand. Rolls off the rim. No good. He missed them both. Bobcats down by two. Shannon brings the ball up court. Bobcats have not sniffed the lead in this one. This is as close as they've gotten. Down low to Drame. Back to the basket. Backs in on Adams. Up with the jump hook. No good. Rebound as a Tam. Back up and he's fouled.
That could be it on Maxwell.
I do believe. Devon Maxwell will pick up the foul, and he fouls out of the game. So he is the top scorer for this Hampton team, and he'll call it a night, fouling out with 14 points.
Well, Quinnipiac has done a great job, Billy, pounding the offensive glass, you know, and that's their 24th offensive rebound. So that's a lot of offensive rebounds, Billy. They really haven't been productive because they've only got 20 points when you could get 48 of those, but it's worn, body blows have worn Hampton down.
First by Azatam is good. Bobcats within one. 2 minutes and 36 seconds remaining. Azatam can get them even here. One more free throw coming. Bends the knees, flips with the right hand, off the mark, no good. Rebound, Hampton. Bobcats down by one. Duran Powers comes across midcourt. Comes along the left sideline, guarded by Hurst. Now accelerates, comes to the top of the key. Hurst stays with him. Now backs out. Directs traffic, comes along the right sideline. 2 minutes and 15 seconds left. 1 point, Hampton lead. Comes to the top of the key, crosses over. Down the right side, still on the floor with eight on the shot clock. Goes to the baseline, hooks a pass in the lane. Reed loses the handle, out of bounds off of Hampton.
Yeah, Quinnipiac caught a break there, Billy. You know, you reached a little bit, but I wasn't effective enough to get a foul. And you get a chance to get ahead, Billy. I think this is your time, right?
2 minutes left. Bobcats down by one. Umar Shannon into the front court. Picked up by Darden. Gives it right side for Conti. Conti gets it top of the key to Azatam. Bounces once. Gives to Umar Shannon along the left sideline. Down low. To Drame, back to the basket, spins to the lane, underneath Azatam, lays it in, and the Bobcats take the lead.
Well, I like the heady play that time by Drame and a real good feed. First time they played tic-tac. Timeout by Hampton, Bobcats got their first lead.
A minute 34 remaining as Quinnipiac, as Billy said, takes their first lead of the game, 66-65.
Well, I like the set play. You know, you got a small team in there with Hampton, Billy. They're not long enough to make a play. But what Hampton did now for the first time all day is they immediately doubled team when Drame caught the ball. He threw probably the most unorthodox bounce pass I think you've ever seen, but it was really effective because no one expected it. And Azatam was by himself to finish.
All right, let's pause right here for station identification on the Bobcats Radio Network.
Quinnipiac basketball exclusively on AM 1220 WQUN Hampton. Drive to work with Ray Andrewson, mornings from 6 to 10.
This one will not go on the Bobcats highlight reel, but they could grind and gut their way out to a win. They're up by one with a minute 34 remaining.
Well, you know, you don't want it to go in the trash. I think that's what happened if they would get beat. You would just burn this thing. But, you know, they battled all the way back, and they've done it in a way that's been very ugly. But, you know, Billy, I talk a lot about the turtle, you know, and the turtle makes progress only when he sticks his neck out. And now Quinnipiac was able to get their neck out a little bit and was able to get back in the basketball game, and now you need to finish this thing up. And it's going to take a group, like I said, that's got a lot of energy left because they haven't played a lot of defense where they got to make a stop.
Could use one here. Minute 34 remaining, and the Bobcats with a one-point lead, 66-65. Hampton with the basketball. Miles Jackson will inbound. Usman Drame will pressure him. Inbounded to Powers at the top of the key. Powers moves to the left side. Now they throw top of the key to Brown. Keron Brown holds the ball, has a pick, picks up the dribble, gets to Darden right side. Darden Looks to make a move, cannot. 12 on the shot clock, gives to Powers, crosses over into the lane, up with the shot, no good. Rebound knocked out of bounds by Hampton.
Well, great defensive effort that time, and you saw the bigs. You saw Drame get active, you know. And when you're 6'9 and you're active, you play like you're 7'6. So, Quinnipiac, real good job defensively. And now you're going to get a chance with the lead, Billy, to really bleed the clock. And you got 35 seconds. Wouldn't be surprised, you know, they run the clock down and Moore takes the timeout to get a set play.
Inbounded to Umar Shannon. Shannon brings the ball up court, comes across the line with a minute 5 remaining. Shannon comes to the right side, guarded by Powers. Wants to get it down low, does to Drame. Backs in, double team, forces the shot, and he's fouled. So Usman Drame will go to the line with 55 seconds remaining, and the Bobcats leading by one.
I thought Hampton did a good job because they really increased pressure on the ball where Quinnipiac had to take the shot. I would have much preferred Quinnipiac hold the thing, Billy, and take time off the clock and protect the lead. But good job by Hampton in making Quinnipiac get to the line and foul them quick.
Drame makes the first. He's got a dozen points.
He's woken up here a little bit in the second half, got a little bit of active, and that one play where he blocked a shot on a foul seemed to get him a little bit of energy.
Second is good. So Drame makes two foul shots. Bobcats with a three-point lead. 54 seconds remaining. Powers out of the backcourt. Powers hands off to Mercado, who's back in. Now to Darden. They got their three-point shooters in the game. Hands to Powers. Powers down the left side to the basket, blocked by Drame and out of bounds.
You tell me where this team was, Willie. Where were they?
Well, they showed up just in time, I think.
That they did, Coach.
22 on the shot clock. Mercado will inbound from the baseline. Looks, lobs it in, top of the key. Knocked away, but recovered by Powers. Powers to the basket. Passes it back out. Mercado for three. In and out. No good. Rebound battled for. Taken by Hampton to Mercado for three. Good.
Ouch. You got to come up with the rebound. You got to come up with the ball, Bobcats. Tie game 28, Willie.
28 seconds remaining as Tom Moore calls a timeout. So the Bobcats, who were behind all night long, forge into the lead, take the lead on an Ike Azatam bucket to take a one-point lead, and then two free throws by Drame got them up by three, but they couldn't get a defensive rebound. And it goes back out, and a three-point shot by Mercado has tied this game at 68.
Good persistence that time. And Mercado, who had missed the first one, Billy, in the right place at the right time, was able to get that long rebound and knock it down. So in pretty good shape for Quinnipiac, Billy. You know, they have the possession arrow for a jump ball. They certainly have the opportunity to get fouled. They're controlling the clock, and pretty good opportunity that Quinnipiac's not only going to get a shot. My guess is they're going to get fouled. The question becomes if Hampton will allow you to walk it down to the very end, or will they increase the tempo and make you score early?
We shall see. Bobcats will be able to inbound the ball without pressure. Conte will throw it in to Umar Shannon. Hurst, Drame, Azatam also on the floor for the Bobcats. Shannon slowly across midcourt. 22 seconds left. Tie game at 68. Shannon dribbles, circle at midcourt. Powers now comes out to play him. Shannon comes along the left sideline. 10 seconds, under 10 seconds. Shannon still dribbling along the left sideline. 6 seconds. Off a pick, 4 seconds. Puts up a three. Good!
Wow! I'm sitting there wondering, when are you going to make a play? When are you going to take a shot? You really would expect him to drive to the basket, but bam, big time three for
Umar Shannon with the three, and a timeout Quinnipiac with 9/10 of a second remaining, and the Bobcats leading 71-68.
So, Willie, there's this thing, SMH, and I know I sent it to you on a couple texts. You remember what SMH is?
No, I don't.
Shaking my head when Shannon had the ball, right?
Yeah.
You're sitting out there, both of us going, dude, what are you going to do? You got to make a play, right?
They weren't making a play, and then all of a sudden he found himself with enough room to take a three, and he had it down all the time.
He knew what he was doing. We just weren't aware of what he was doing, right, partner?
Shake my head.
SMH, baby. All right, so now, Billy, you got .9, which is going to be very difficult for Hampton to be able to catch and shoot.
Well, if I'm Quinnipiac here, I'm going to put Drame on the guy inbounding the ball.
Well, I tell you what, I like that play, Schweitz. I like that. I get make them throw it long, try to tip the ball, and then be active on the ball. And I would be aggressive going after the basketball to try to intercept the pass. Because what's the worst thing that happens, Billy?
You foul them, they get two shots.
And the game's over, and Quinnipiac wins because the buzzer sounds. Well, Umar Shannon had been 1-for-11, Billy, until the last minute of the game. He made two field goals, none bigger than that big-time three.
He's got 11 points, but as Billy said, was struggling all night long shooting the ball. But his three has the – and they went back, and then there's now 1.6 on the clock. Tom Moore took my advice, and Drame will – guard the man inbounding the ball. Everybody for Hampton is in the back court. Keron Brown looks, still looking, gets it in, off the hands of Powers. Mercado fires it up off the backboard, no good, and the Bobcats hold on and win it. Final score, Quinnipiac 71, Hampton 68. Stay tuned for tomorrow Motors postgame show right after this. Zaid Hurst throws up ahead for Shannon. Comes along the left sideline. Gets it down low. Azatam drives to the basket. No good. Rebound. Drame! Reverse layup is good.
Quinnipiac Bobcats basketball brought to you by TD Bank, America's most convenient bank. By Pepsi, the choice of a new generation. By Dunkin' Donuts, America runs on Dunkin'. By Moro Motors, Mercedes-Benz and BMW.